Here's America, where the power of the pyramid is working for you. It appeared that Andre Waters slipped and fell in that pass coverage, Hank.
Yeah, I couldn't see what happened. Something had to, they had a blow coverage or somebody had to fall, Jack, to have a guy wide open on that kind of a play. But I can't imagine Waters covering McKinnon. That's a mismatch to begin with.
Three plays, 67 yards, 22 seconds on the Bears' lead, and Butler kicks it off. Abercrombie is deep with Jenkins, and the ball is taken by Jenkins on the 13 to the 20, to the 25, 30, and down near the 35-yard line. A strong return by Izell Jenkins, and a little scuffle breaks out upfield as one of the Eagles went after the kicker. Lorenzo Lynch downfield to make the tackle. Still no flags in this game. That was a 22-yard return and not a very good kickoff by Butler.
You know, both kickers, watching them before the game in a pregame warm-up, either one of the two kickers got the ball deep, very deep downfield.
Now the Eagles have the ball for the second time at their 35, going from our right to our left. Byers in the backfield, along with Anthony Toney. And on a first down call, here's a pass play by Cunningham, and it's caught near midfield. And a first down for the Eagles, their first of the game. Mike Quick caught the ball, and Mike Richardson played the ball and just missed the interception.
That's the great thing about Cunningham. He's got a lot of velocity. You talk about a tight spin and a great rotation. He's got that, and the ball gets there a little quicker than you think it will get there when it takes off from his fingers.
He really zipped that one out to Mike Quick. Carter goes to the right. Quick is to the left. Byers the tailback. Another pass on first down. Cunningham fakes short, throws long. It's caught inside the 40-yard line, down inside the 35-yard line. Taken by Chris Carter, a 17-yard gain over Bestie Jackson. And Cunningham was cool on that one.
Yes, he was. And I was watching Hampton on the last play trying to get a rush from his right tackle position. He didn't look like he got off the ball extremely well. They contained him well. And Cunningham took a short drop and whizzed it right in there.
Cunningham is two in a row. A fine catch by Chris Carter on the heels of a good catch by Mike Quick. They're at the Bears 33. A first down run to Byers, and he is knocked down at the 30. A three-yard pickup ran into Mike Singletary. Second and seven, Philadelphia. Philadelphia trying to answer the challenge after the Bears hit them hard with a 64-yard scoring pass to Dennis McKinnon. And they have a good drive going now. And we have 10:40 left in the first quarter of this game. Bears on top, 7-0.
Both teams have to run the ball enough to keep the other team defense honest, but they're going to win the game in this kind of weather. How well they throw the ball.
Carter to the right, Quick to the left, second and seven from the 30. Here, a flag goes down as Cunningham throws, runs now, down to the 25 and knocked down near the 23-yard line. That might be enough for a first down, but the Bears were offside. Jim Morrissey made that tackle, and Cunningham showed the threat that he is when he starts to run. Dan Hampton put the pressure on.
Well, Hampton was offside on the play. That's why he got across there like he did. I think it was Hampton who was offside on the play, Jack.
And if the Eagles accept the penalty, it'll be second down and two. The run by Cunningham, apparently a yard short of a first down.
Offside, defense number 99, penalty is accepted, it'll still be second down.
Second and two as they mark off five against the Bears on the first penalty of the game and put the ball at the Chicago 25. 7-0 the Bears leading in the early going. Randall Cunningham. He completed 54% of his passes during the year.
A good time for a play-action pass here, Jack.
Let's see what Cunningham does. He starts Byers in motion. He's good at catching the ball. There's a pass to Brock down. It was intended for Byers and knocked down by Al Harris, who almost intercepted the ball.
I don't think it was a movement play that time, play-action, but it was a pass, a rollout to that right side, but it didn't look like Cunningham got enough depth. And as a result, he had to throw right through that defensive end. And as big as Harris is, he knocked the ball down, didn't have a chance to get the flaps up, and falls incomplete.
Harris at 6'5", got his paws up in the air and knocked it down. And now it's third and two, a crucial down for the Eagles.
That's why the play action is so much better. You keep the hands down with a play action fake.
Toney is the running back. Third down and two. Cunningham rolls left to throw. He throws. It's incomplete. It went off the hands of the receiver with Morrissey covering. On Keith Byers, the pass was high and away, and a field goal try coming up for the Eagles.
That's murder to have second and two, Jack, and blow the opportunity to get 2 yards. And now they have to try a field goal.
This will be a 43-yard try. The longest of the year by Zendejas was 50 yards. Alexander will snap the ball.
And he's used to kicking on synthetic turf. He didn't kick very well on grass before the game.
There's a snap. They get it down. There's the kick. The kick is long enough. And no good. It went off to the left. And Zendejas misses. And that Eagle drive was for naught. They had second and two, as Hank reminded you. They didn't make it on a second down pass or a third down pass. And now the Bears take over. The Bears have the lead. 7-0. Let's take them out.
This butt's for all you do, hard riding buckaroo. You're tall in the saddle, making doggy ski daddle. Give a yippee tie, you come. You really make it work, and this butt's for you. You really make it work, and this butt's for you.
Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
Bears take over at their 25. We'll be back in a moment.
Hi, this is Harry Anderson with a tip from the Arthritis Foundation. If arthritis makes it difficult for you to shake hands, here's something that can help. Try to grasp the other person's wrist as they extend their hand to you. This prevents the person from squeezing your hand. That's just one of the simple but ingenious ways that you can make life with arthritis a little easier. And you can find many more helpful hints at your local chapter of the Arthritis Foundation. Give them a call. They'll be glad to help. They know it's time we took arthritis seriously.
She has blonde hair, blue eyes, and peaches and cream skin. The all-American girl? Not quite. She's half American, born and living in Asia, and she lives not only with poverty, but with prejudice against her American looks. The Pearl S. Buck Foundation is dedicated to helping her and thousands of children like her in Vietnam, South Korea, Thailand, Taiwan, Okinawa, and the Philippines. This is Tony Franciosa. Please call the Pearl S. Buck Foundation. 1-800-523-5328.
Mike Tomczak will direct his crew. You didn't like the Philadelphia play calling, Hank.
That's terrible, Jack. You know, you got second and two. You got two downs to make 2 yards. And you throw the ball both times and don't come close to making the completed pass. Now you try a field goal, you come away with nothing after a good drive.
Actually, they were at the 25-yard line, Hank. They had 3 downs to make 2 yards.
That's right.
Now the Bears go back to work with Thomas Sanders in the lineup and as the tailback in the I formation. Suey is the upback, 3 wide receivers. Sanders goes in motion. And a long snap down and a pass play on first down. Tomczak throws, intercepted. Back the other way come the Eagles to the 30-yard line, and the tackle is made as the interception was by the linebacker, Seth Joyner. A terrible pass by Tomczak, falling back as he threw. Seth Joyner intercepted and was tackled at the Chicago 30-yard line.
And that's what happens when you don't get a chance, Jack, to step, follow through, and get something on the ball. You throw it falling away. It's a problem.
So the Bears commit the first turnover. And now the Eagles are at the 30-yard line with Chicago on top 7-0.
And that was a safety blitz.
Quick and Carter come to the left. Cunningham under center. Third wide receiver to the right side, and Cunningham hands the ball off to Tony. He is knocked down right at the line of scrimmage. There was quite a mix-up on the handoff, and Sean Smith, the defensive end, made the tackle. Hampton was also in on the play, and Smith was a little slow in getting up. No gain on that one by the Eagles. No timing at all on that handoff, Hank.
No, it wasn't. And again, you know, talking about turnover, since Buddy Ryan has been with the Philadelphia Eagles, 1986, they were +9. Last year, and +13. This year, +18.
+18 with interceptions and fumbles. Second and 10 for Cunningham. He is back to throw. Four-man rush over the middle, caught inside the 20. Inside the 15 for a first down to the 11-yard line. And that one was taken down by the tight end, Keith Jackson, the rookie out of Oklahoma, and a pro bowler, a 19-yard pickup, and did he throw a fastball?
He threw a fastball, and I tell you the other thing, Keith Jackson, the great thing about him is he's not only got good hands, he's a good blocker coming from Oklahoma. Durison was on him man for man. He broke underneath Durison, the ball was, but he runs so well once he makes the catch.
And Doug,
one guy's not going to tackle him, Jack.
Douglas made the tackle at the 11-yard line, and so the Eagles are trying to turn the turnover into a touchdown. Here is a handoff to Byers and a quick pop up the middle. Stopped at the 9, falls forward to the 8. He got 3 yards, and Singletary stopped the play.
I think if Philadelphia looked at pictures of the New England game, he realized, and also Minnesota, the best way to run at the Bears is to run right at them, and then occasionally to try to get outside quickly. But they react and pursue so well that it's hard to bring the ball from one part of the formation all the way over from the other side to get outside against the Bears.
John Smith was injured on the previous play. The defensive end, the ball is at the 9. Second down and 8 for Cunningham. He's back to throw. The blitz he throws, incomplete. And the blitz made him cough it up, and it's 3rd down and 8. Chris Carter, the intended receiver.
I think the one thing that's important, Jack, when you're playing against the Bears in that 8-man front, when you see it, you got to make sure that you get good security, keep everybody in and block, let the 3 guys get out, the receivers, and you got one-for-one coverage. But it has to begin with good security.
Todd Crum becomes the additional defensive back, and Sean Smith is returned to the lineup at defensive end. The Eagles are already within easy field goal pickings. And now Cunningham lines up in the shotgun, the line of scrimmage, the 9-yard line. There's a snap, and flags go down. The Eagles were in motion. The pass is caught, and it's a touchdown, but the Eagles were in motion. That's going to be brought back, I'm sure. The pass was caught by Chris Carter in the end zone, but a penalty against the Eagles will make it 3rd down and 13. Third and 13.
Failing a motion. Back was moving forward. It's still 3rd down.
It is 3rd and 13. It's the Chicago 14. In the first quarter, the Bears lead 7.5 left in the period. 7-0 our score.
And the Eagles came into the game with 115 penalties for the season.
Dick Chapura comes in to help with the pass rush for Chicago. Cunningham lines up in the shotgun. 3rd down and long for the Eagles. There's the snap. Cunningham to throw. No pressure. Now there is. Now he runs. Now he throws. And it is batted around. And touchdown in the end zone. Mike Quick caught the ball before it came down. It touched 3 people, and the Eagles have scored. The flag is down. Let's see what the flag is about.
It might be pass interference.
It's holding against the Eagles. So another call against them. It comes back. 2 touchdowns have been called back by penalties.
Boy, that hurts. That really hurts, talking about the Eagles.
Now it even hurts their field goal chances, Hank. The ball was batted around by numerous people in the end zone and caught by Mike Quick before it hit the deck. But a holding call against the Eagles. Here's the referee.
Holding. 25. Offense. Still 3rd down.
Anthony Toney was caught holding as he tried to protect Cunningham. Now they move the ball back to the 25. And it is 3rd down and long, 3rd and 24. Mike Quick caught the ball, which was batted around in the end zone. Made a diving catch before it hit the turf. It was touched by one Bear, then one Eagle, then another Eagle, and then the 4th man to touch it was Quick, but they called it back. And now Cunningham gets under center at the 25-yard line. 3rd down. 3-man front for the Bears. There's the snap. And Cunningham to throw. He throws into the end zone. And it is broken up. Broken up by Bestie Jackson. That was a Hail Mary kind of pass. Into the end zone and intended for Mike Quick. But now the Eagles will have to try another field goal.
And here again, he threw the ball badly. He's got a strong arm that Cunningham has, Jack, but he threw that one falling away, trying to get it over the top of Vesty Jackson. I tell you, Vesty Jackson is turning out to be a lot better back than he used to be. He's getting so much attention, so many people are throwing at him, that he gets better and better all the time with all the work that he's getting during the game.
Here's another 43-yard field goal by Zendejas, who missed one a while back. The ball was snapped by Alexander, held by Telchik, the punter. And there's the snap and the kick. This one is long enough, and it is good. And the Eagles are on the board following the interception. They trail 7-3 with 7:04 left in the first quarter. Bears on top. Let's take time out.
Something shipped internationally fast? Well, there's good news in the air. Flying Tigers International Distribution Service. IDS gives you next-day delivery from Asia and Europe to the U.S. And with no size or weight restrictions, you're not limited to just envelopes and small packages. So whether you're shipping from Tokyo to Tampa, Dusseldorf to Dallas, or just Seattle to San Francisco, call Flying Tigers because
we're taking care of business.
Look and look again. It's a totally new automobile, yet you know what it is. You've never seen it, but you recognize it immediately. The classic lines, the distinctive shape. Contemporary as a car can be, yet it recalls a grand tradition. It's obviously the Riviera, the 1989 Buick Riviera. It's a classic all over again.
So the Eagles had to settle for a field goal after having two touchdowns called back because of penalties. Let's pause 10 seconds for stations to identify themselves on the CBS Radio Network.
You want more than just the scores? I'm Mike Cairns, and I've got them for you every weekday morning right here on your sports leader in the Capital District, WQBK-Rensselaer, Albany, Schenectady, Troy.
They call that a 42-yard field goal by Zendejas, who will now kick it off. Thomas Sanders and Dennis Gentry are at the 5-yard line for the Bears. Rather slow-moving first quarter, 7:04 remaining. Bears on top 7-3. Here's the kick by Zendejas. It's high and deep. And taken by Gentry on the 3. Slips, regains his balance, comes to the 15, and that's all. And the kickoff is out to the Chicago 14 or 15-yard line, and Seth Joyner intercepted a pass a moment ago. Made that tackle. Well, I'm sure the Eagles are settled into this game, Hank, and they're rather new to postseason play, but they should be comfortable.
Yeah, I would think so. Talking to them before the game, as we mentioned, they're all very, very confident, very good about their week of preparation. So it shouldn't be a problem.
The Bears start from their 14-yard line, and Thomas Sanders is the tailback. And Thornton goes off on a wing. He's the tight end. Now Thornton in motion, and Tom Zach delays the ball to Sanders, and he returns out to the 18-yard line. He got 4 yards on the draw play. He ran into the arms of Wes Hopkins, the free safety, and a strong tackler. They're happy to have him back.
Yeah, he's a good player. He really is. He does an average many carries a game, probably about 5 or 6. But he's got ability and the kind of skill to make good plays and big plays.
Matt Hopkins is a very good safety, Hank.
Oh, he's a linebacker playing safety. He's a terrific tackler, not a very good cover guy. But when they put him in an 8-man line, he's murdered.
Second down and 6-4 Chicago. Muster is in their lineup. Motion by the tight end. Here's the running play to Sanders, and he is short of the 20-yard line. Third and long coming up, and neither team can run the ball. Another scuffle breaks out as Joyner, the linebacker, made the tackle. Sanders kind of felt his way in there, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. Of course, there was no place to go, and as a result, but in that situation, you've got to make a decision, right or wrong, make it and run.
Chicago at the 20-yard line, their own 20, third down and 4. Last time Tomczak threw the ball, he was intercepted. He was only intercepted six times during the regular season. They're having a little trouble with the game clock, which they are resetting at the moment. 5:37 remaining in the first period. 7-3 in favor of Chicago.
Camp Bozo that time, the tight end, really got a terrific block on Reggie White, number 92. Hit him right down on the ground. Pancake.
White playing the nose at the moment. Simmons, the right defensive end. The Eagles moving all over the place as the snap goes to Tomczak. There's the snap, and Tomczak to throw over the middle, and it's caught beyond the 30. A magnificent catch was made by Dennis McKinnon. He got the touchdown earlier, and he reached high and almost a one-handed grab with Andre Waters covering him.
And the other thing that happened, Tomczak, with all that pressure, how he got the ball through there, I don't know, but he did a terrific job of getting the ball to McKinnon on the play. They were right in his face. Reggie White was coming on in the middle area, was knocked down right about the time he was trying to get the hands up, or else it had really been trouble for Tomczak.
Good job by the offensive line that time. And now Tomczak gets under center at his own 34. The center is Hilgenberg. Thayer and Bortz are the guards. Covert and Van Horn the tackles. First down throw by Tomczak. Throws outside of the left, and it is batted down incomplete beyond the 35-yard line. A short pattern to the tight end Thornton. Todd Bell was covering. The pass was incomplete.
The Eagles are playing, you know, they normally like to play an awful lot of man-for-man coverage. They're playing a lot more zone here this afternoon. It looks like it's about 50-50 from a percentage standpoint.
These two teams really slugging it out at the line of scrimmage. A good offensive line for the Bears and a tough defense for the Eagles. Tomczak is 2 out of 7 with one touchdown throw and one pass intercepted. On 2nd and 10, here's a give to Sanders running left. Makes his cut and is hauled down from behind after crossing the 35 to the 37. And Reichenbach, the middle linebacker, made the tackle. Here's another 3rd and long for Chicago.
Well, there again, Jack, that's a formation split backfield where the back has to run. He's lined up behind his right tackle, and the gap between the guard and the tackle has to run all the way across the formation. Both teams pursue and react so well that that kind of a play is very, very difficult to run successfully.
3rd down and 8 for Chicago at their own 36-yard line. They just hit on a 3rd down pass a moment ago. They send Morris and McKinnon to the right. And the rookie Davis is the wide receiver to the left. Out of the shotgun, another pass play. Tomczak looks and throws over the middle. Wide open, McKinnon. First down into Philadelphia territory, down to the 42-yard line. A 22-yard pass play with Waters covering. And by the way, the Eagles gave up a high percentage of passes this year on defense.
54%. And that time they caught him in the zone again, Jack. They caught him in the zone. They were trying to play underneath. He hit the seam between the safety man and the corner. And Tomczak put it right on the money, and Reggie White that time, the defensive left end, didn't get much of a rush at all on Tomczak.
Van Horn really stifled him.
Yes, he did.
Now here's a 1st down call at the Eagle 42. Two key 3rd down plays have been completed by Chicago. Here's a 1st down pass out in the flat, and it's caught. The play is good for 2, 3, 4, about 5 yards on a tough catch and run by Sanders. He was bumped out by Roynell Young, and a lot of people like to pick on Roynell Young.
Yeah, he's been there for a long time, a good man-for-man coverage guy, but very susceptible to double moves. And a lot of people, especially down inside of 30-35, like to go to the post and back out to the corner on him.
The ball is to the Eagles 34.
Nice-looking drive by the Chicago Bears, engineered by Mike Tomczak.
2nd down and 2. Sanders and Muster are in the backfield. Tight end is on a wing. That's Bozo. Now they put him up on the line of scrimmage. And Tomczak takes the ball and hands it off. Muster is stopped after about a half-yard gain. And it's 3rd and short for Chicago, with Joyner making the Eagle tackle. He hasn't impressed you in any of the games we've seen.
No, he hasn't, except against Minnesota late in the 4th quarter. I think he made a couple of runs. But he doesn't get off the ball quickly enough He's fast, I think, once he gets going, Jack, but he isn't quick off the ball, and that's very important for a running back. And as I mentioned several times, not a criticism of him at all, but I think he's going to wind up being a better tight end than he would a running back.
The Bears are 3 out of 4 on third down, and they have a 3rd and 2 now at the Philadelphia 34-yard line. Bears leading 7-3 first quarter. And Muster stays in the lineup, and Harbaugh, or Tomczak, lines up in the shotgun. Takes the snap, and it sets up to throw. He throws, and it is incomplete. And there was tough coverage on Morris, the wide receiver, by the extra back, William Frizzell, and it's 4th down, and a perplexing call for the Bears at the Philadelphia 34. And they're going to punt the ball. Tomczak had time. Now they send Kevin Butler in there, and he'll try a long field goal. His longest of the year is 45 yards, and this is going to be a 52-yard attempt. The ball will be held by Wagner, and Butler will kick it. There's a good snap and the kick. He got into it pretty well, but it is short and no good. So it's a 52-yard miss by Kevin Butler, and the ball goes over to the Eagles. And the Bears were in the same situation, Hank. They had 2nd and 2 and never did make it.
Yeah, it's amazing. It's hard to understand that mentality, because in a game like this, when you got to keep making first downs, when you got 2 downs to get 2 yards, if you can't do it running the ball, they're doing especially a play action. But just to go back in the pocket and try to throw the ball that way, Jack, it just doesn't make a lot of sense.
So the ball is at the Philadelphia 34. And the Eagles have taken over with 1:36 remaining in the first quarter. This Eagle offense can burn you in a hurry. They have fires at the tailback spot. Here's a toss to Byers and a reverse to Carter, and it's a fake reverse and the tackle made at the 39-yard line and a 5-yard pickup. Vesty Jackson made the tackle. Byers carried on the fake reverse.
A gain of 5.
That kind of a play, it can be very effective, and especially if you have a player who has the capacity to fake that reverse and then throw from it also on the reverse action. Very effective.
2nd and 5 for the Eagles. Byers and Tony in the backfield. A pass by Cunningham. He throws out in the flat, and it's caught beyond the 45 for a first down. And Byers has a first down into Bears territory at the 48, and he has become a terrific receiver. Byers caught 72 passes this year.
And that's unusual from a player who played collegiate football at Ohio State, where they ran the ball so much, and he very rarely ever made a catch. And I talked to him several weeks ago, and he said he worked diligently on his pass patterns, especially against man-for-man coverage, and has paid great dividends this season.
The defender had his back to the play, and Cunningham hit Byers, first down to the Chicago 48. And a first down call by Randall Cunningham. He's changing the play at the line of scrimmage. The crowd noise is bothering him a bit. Cunningham is back to throw. No pressure, and he throws long down the right sideline. Heavy coverage, and it's incomplete at the goal line, and darn near taken down by Mike Quick. Quick had heavy coverage by Mike Richardson, and that was anybody's ball at the goal line.
Well, you know what happened on the play? Cunningham was confused, Jack. He anticipated a man-for-man coverage, and at the last moment, the Bears changed from man-to-man to zone. They really had a soft zone, and tried to throw the ball up on top against the zone, especially on Richardson, is very, very difficult to do.
Cunningham is 4 out of 10. He had a couple of completions called back because of penalties. And it's 2nd down and 10 now at the Chicago 48. Chris Carter is to the left, Mike Quick to the right. The blitz is on. The pass is thrown and caught by Byers. He has a first down, breaks tackles, and goes down to the Chicago 24-yard line. They beat the blitz with a quickie to Byers over the middle.
That's the recognition thing I talked about earlier, Jack. You have to take advantage. When you get the opportunity, you know you're going to get man-for-man coverage. You got to get the ball to one of the receivers and hope for a big play. They got pressured there again. He's got such a great arm. He threw the ball, falling away a little bit that time, but got it right on the money to Byers.
Byers broke a couple of tackles and got some additional yards before Jim Morrissey tackled him in the Chicago 24, and there was a 24-yard pickup. Now we have no more time left in the first quarter. The gun sounds. The Bears have a 7-3 lead, and the Eagles are on the march. First down at the Bears' 24-yard line. That's the end of the first quarter. Let's pause for this word.
If I were to say to you the two words talk show, probably the first name that wouldn't pop into your head is Pat Sajak. But think about it. He's warm and friendly. Well, you'll be able to see all this for yourself when the Pat Sajak Show comes to CBS Late Night. It's not going to be Johnny, and it's not going to be Dave. You're going to be surprised. Make a break for Pat Sajak weeknights beginning January 9th on CBS Late Night. So the next time you hear the two words talk show, what's the first name that'll come to mind? Okay, then what's the second?
In 1965, John Fuller thought he was buying his dream house. But today he realized what he was also buying was a college education for his daughter, a new swimming pool, and a cruise for his 25th anniversary. You see, over the years, the equity in his house has increased dramatically. And thanks to a home equity loan from Transamerica Financial Services, John has been able to make some of his other dreams come true. And just think, all he thought he was buying was a house. Transamerica. The power of the pyramid is working for you. With many car repair guarantees is they run out of gas after 90 days. But not the lifetime service guarantee from participating Ford and Lincoln Mercury dealers. Once you pay for a covered repair, it's guaranteed in writing with free parts and labor for as long as you own your car. Ask your dealer for a copy of the lifetime service guarantee, because peace of mind is protection long after others would abandon you.
We start the second quarter here at Soldier Field, Chicago, the NFC Divisional Playoff game. The Bears lead 7-3 at the end of the first quarter. And CBS Radio Sports coverage of the National Football League is sponsored by Toshiba Facsimile Systems, by Budweiser, by Campbell's Chunky Soup, and by Buick and your Buick dealer. Another good drive for the Eagles is underway. And Meyer Byers is killing them, coming out of the backfield and catching the ball.
Yeah, he runs a lot of option patterns on linebackers where he has a choice of going inside and outside, and has really been very adept at doing that.
Five-man front for Chicago is Cunningham on first down, back to throw again. He throws over the middle, and it's caught inside the 15, and that's a big gain. And another catch by the tight end, Keith Jackson. The coverage by Ron Rivera, the linebacker, and it's tough to cover him. 11 yards, a first down.
Well, the Bears are playing a lot of zone. I mentioned it, and they're playing a zone again this time. He gets a free release that time off the line of scrimmage, and he just anchors in the hole. The ball's thrown at the numbers, and he picks up another first down. And they're not getting a lot of pressure, I should add, on Cunningham.
This is the sixth play of the drive coming up, and they're down to the Chicago 13 with a first down. Quick goes to the left. Tight end Jackson's on the right side. Carter also to the left. Cunningham to throw again. He looks and he's rushed and he is sacked. He gets away. He runs to the 15, but the whistle had sounded and he was in the grasp of Sean Smith. And that's where that rule really hurts a quarterback such as Cunningham.
Yeah, it's a bad rule, Jack. I've said it many, many times. We're now recruiting people to play quarterback who are athletes, who have great escapability skill, and now we're depriving them of the opportunity to take advantage of that ability. It used to be, you know, Johnny Unitas, all those great quarterbacks did not have great movement. They should have been the ones who had should have had the protection, not the modern-day quarterback or the contemporary quarterback who has that running ability to make big plays.
So Cunningham, who was sacked 57 times during the year, is caught for the first time today, and it's second and 20. Here, back to throw is Cunningham. Has time. A flag is down. There's the pass to Byers. He's tackled at the 15. Now we'll check the flag. And we're going to have a holding call against Philadelphia. That'll make it second down and 30.
You know, the Chicago Bear defense came into this game with 43 sacks, 38 of which were made by the defensive line.
They mark off 10 more yards.
Still second down.
The call against Dave Remington, the center who used to wear the Bengals uniform. Bengals play Seattle later today. You'll hear that game at 3:45 Eastern Time on CBS Radio with Brad Shan and Randy Rasmussen. Third and 30. Second and 30. Three penalties against the Eagles.
Hampton hasn't been able to do much in there. It looks like he's handicapped a little bit with that bad knee.
Cunningham gets under center and checks out the defense. Back to throw. Here's a draw play to Tony and tackled back at the 35-yard line by Mike Singletary. A loss on that one.
Another eight-man line, Jack. That's a, two times they try to run that counter trap play. They call it counter OT. Second time they try to run it with the off-guard pulling, and there was a leak that time. Hard to do that against the eight-man front. You got to pump it up and get it up on top.
Third and 32. They had a first down at the Chicago 13, then the sack, then the holding. Now the loss on the draw play. Michael Haddix is in the backfield for the Eagles. Third and 32. Cunningham is under center. Takes the snap and back to throw. He looks and throws long, and it's caught at the 10, 5, and it's going to be first and goal for the Philadelphia Eagles as Cunningham hit his man inside the 5-yard line, and it's first and goal at the 4. Ron Johnson caught it, and Jackson tackled him, and what a throw by Cunningham.
Beautiful, and here again, he had plenty of time, and Jack, it was a zone defense, a big hole in the zone between the safety man and the corner. Linebackers trying to get depth. Durison's on a line of scrimmage, going back into the zone too. All the time in the world, he steps, throws, and when he can do that, Jack, boy, he is murder.
Let's see if they made the first down inside the 5-yard line. And they did not. It's going to be fourth down and about a foot. Fourth down and about a foot, and let's see if the Eagles want to take the 3 points or gamble. And this is a big, big decision here, Henry. As they measured for International Delivery Service, that really measures up, call Flying Tigers. At Flying Tigers, they're taking care of business. They're going for it.
I think they got to go for it, Jack. I think they have to go for it. Come on, hurry up, get off the field, they're saying. Hurry up.
They have three tight ends, including Giles and Little. The running back is Haddix. Cunningham with a sneak. He is hit, but he surges forward, driven back, and let's see where he got the ball down. He stuck that big paw out and put it inside the 4-yard line, and that is going to give him a first down, Hank. The size of Cunningham gave him the first down.
Those long arms come in handy for a lot of different reasons.
Now they're going to measure again, but from where we saw it, he made the first down inside the 3.
I thought they had a pretty good surge when he hit it to begin with on a quarterback sneak.
It's going to be, well, did they stop him? It's a very close measurement, and the referee, Jim Tunney, has a tough decision to make. The Bears think they stopped him. The Eagles think they have a first down.
And it looks like they did stop him, Jack. Let's see where they're trying to get a picture on the TV screen here. It looks like it might be a little short.
They're still measuring. Now they indicate that the Bears stopped them at the 3-yard line. You wouldn't believe how close it came. A sneak to the 3, and the ball goes over to the Bears.
That was within a pebble on the football from being a first down, Jack.
Now some of the Eagles want a further measurement, but the referee has already indicated that the ball has gone over to Chicago. They missed it by an inch, and they passed up the field goal opportunity. And the Eagles are crying about this one. The ball belongs to Chicago.
I didn't think, you know, when I saw the official get over there and mark the ball, I thought it might be short.
There's a timeout. Let us take timeout.
I say to you, my goal-oriented friends, recommending a fax by Toshiba can be a mighty fine career move.
You will rise through the ranks, and your boss will give thanks for the wonderful things fax simply brings to the business at hand.
Perspicacious is he who persuades the personnel in the front office that Toshiba facsimile can spare the company the woes of high phone and courier bills. Far-reaching are the effects of a feisty little machine that can send words and pictures over ordinary, I say ordinary, everyday phone lines in as little as 15 seconds. In a word, friends, facsimile pays with a capital P, and that rhymes with T, and that stands for Toshiba, who will put you in touch with tomorrow, take away business headaches and sorrow.
Toshiba, Toshiba.
Toshiba facsimile. So good for your company.
For a free demonstration or more information about Toshiba facsimile system, call 1-800-635-1220.
What is this beer called Michelob Dry? It just might be the best beer you've ever tasted. Boastful? Maybe. But when you take the best natural ingredients and brew them longer, the result is something special. Here's a beer that starts bold, finishes clean, and refreshes completely. Here's a beer you've got to try. New Michelob Dry. One taste, and you'll drink it dry. Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
Well, if the Eagles lose this one, they'll look back at that play. They passed up the field goal opportunity. You still think that was the thing to do, Hank?
Oh, I think so, sure. I think in this kind of a game, you gotta play the game to win it. And when you get down to that close, there's no reason in the world why a professional football team can't get that kind of yardage.
Now the Eagle defense will have to stuff it to the Bears in order to force them to punt and get the ball back in a good field position.
And Bears have only averaged 1.8 on first and 10.
Wendell Davis, a wide receiver, is in, and he comes to the left along with Ron Morris. They have Suey and Muster in there, or Anderson in the backfield for the Bears. Tomczak under center with Morris in motion. Hands the ball off to Suey, and he gains nothing. Well, he maybe got 1 yard to the five. He was a little slippery back where he was starting, and he ran into Jerome Brown. It's tough to run against these Eagles.
It really is, both teams. It's tough to run against the Bears, and it's tough to run against the Eagles. And that play, the other consideration that Buddy Ryan had to make was, so if we don't make it, they're still in the soup. They've got a long way to go. And we still have good field position. We should come out of a good field position. We get into a good crack of it.
Yep, Bozo is the tight end. He is on the right side. They split Anderson out. Keep Suey in the backfield. And from the end zone, the pass play out in the flat. The play out to the 10. A fumble. The Eagles recover the ball, I believe. They have it. The Eagles have it inside the 15-yard line. The Eagles have it on the second turnover. The pass was caught by Suey. He fumbled the ball and then was injured as he dived in and tried to recover the ball. And Wes Hopkins came up with it at the Chicago Bear 14-yard line. A pass and a fumble to Suey. And he's hurt, Hank, with his shoulder hanging as he comes off. But Bozo is the one who caught the ball and fumbled, and then Suey, trying to recover it, was hurt. And the ball is back at the Chicago 14, and the Eagles are having all kinds of chances on first down. Cunningham changes the play.
They're going to run right if they run.
Here's a toss to the tailback, Tony, running right and slamming down near the 11-yard line. He got about 3 yards on that carry and ran into Dan Hampton. Hampton's been making a lot of tackles.
Yeah, he's doing a pretty good job going sideways, but he hasn't really got any penetration to speak of on the pass rush.
Join Hank Stram and me tomorrow afternoon. We'll be at Candlestick Park, the other NFC Divisional playoff game, the 49ers and the Vikings. Tune in Brent Musburger's pregame show starting at 3:45 Eastern, sponsored by Saginaw Tilt Wheel. Second down and 7 for the Eagles. Back to throw is Cunningham. He looks and looks and looks and looks and runs and runs. And now he is tackled back at the 12-yard line. And he lost the yard. No one could shake loose in the end zone. And finally, Ron Rivera, the linebacker, tackled him. And he is put down at the, back at the 11-yard line.
Ron Rivera was in a good striking position all the way, Jack. He did not go at all for the pump fake, and he kept his feet on the ground, good tackling position, and finally made the open field tackle. Tough to do on Cunningham.
Later today and earlier tomorrow, Brad Sham and Randy Rasmussen will bring you the other action. Tomorrow, the Bills in Houston at 12:15 Eastern. Here's a third down and 7 call for Cunningham, back to throw. He throws into the end zone, and it's dropped. A sure touchdown pass by Keith Jackson. He blew it in the end zone.
That's hard to believe. If you'd have told me beforehand that he would have a chance to make a touchdown catch in the end zone, Keith Jackson, and would drop it, I'd say you're crazy. But that's exactly what he did.
It was wide open, too wide open. He went up with both hands, had the ball, and dropped it. And then it was darn near intercepted in the end zone. But instead, here's a field goal try of 29 yards by Zendejas. He has made one, missed one. Telchuk holding the ball. Trying to get the Eagles within a point. A low snap, they get it down. There's the kick, it's up and good. And the Eagles, who have had a touchdown call back twice, have just missed one in the end zone. And with 9:17 remaining in the half, it's the Bears by one, 7-6. Let's take time out.
The sound of football, translated by Campbell's Chunky Soup.
I'm so hungry I could tear your head off. Brunsky better not have eaten that last can of Chunky or I'll get him. My stomach growls one more time and this defensive donkey's history. Thinking about those tender chunks of chicken and beef in Chunky makes me crazy. Sorry to run you into the ground, but it's time for some Chunky.
Campbell's Chunky Soup. It takes care of the meanest appetites.
The Eagles have capitalized on two Bear turnovers, but only with 6 points. Back in a moment.
Listen to the words and music of Savings Bonds 1942.
Any bonds today?
Any bonds today?
Any bonds today? Bonds of freedom, that's what I'm selling. Any bonds today?
Scrape up the most you can. Here comes the freedom man.
Asking you to buy a share of freedom today.
Any stamp today.
U.S. savings bonds were good then. They're even better now. Buy it where you work, through payroll savings. Now more than ever, U.S. savings bonds are a great deal.
Let's pause 10 seconds for stations to identify themselves on the CBS Radio Network.
Sports Talk, Monday through Friday from 5:40 till 7 p.m., as well as sports commentaries at 8:25 and 5:20. Right here at your sports leader, WQBK-Rensselaer, Albany, Schenectady, and Troy.
Hank, the Eagles recovered a fumble on the 14, intercepted a pass at the Chicago 40, and only have 6 points.
It's amazing, isn't it? It really is.
Zendejas will kick it off, and Thomas Sanders is deep along with Dennis Gentry. There's a flag. Philadelphia was offside, so this is a free return from the 10 to Sanders, who is tackled at the 22, and they might make them kick it over. The Eagles were offside. Scott Curtis downfield to make that tackle. The man on the far left side was offside, and probably the Bears will have him kick it over. So the penalties are piling up on the Eagles. A couple of them negated touchdown passes earlier in the first quarter. We have 9:07 remaining in the half.
They're going to make them kick it again.
It's a 5-yard penalty.
So they'll kick from the 30-yard line now. 4 penalties against Philadelphia. 1 against Chicago. And look at those rushing yards, Hank. A total of 28 for the two teams.
Philadelphia 16, Chicago 12. But again, you got to expect that. That's the way it's going to be when you play against these two teams. They're determined to stop the run. They put a lot of people on the line of scrimmage, and they force you to throw the ball.
The Bears allowed only 83 yards per game rushing, and the Eagles allowed only 103. There's still one dominant person thus far we've seen in this game, Hank, and that's Cunningham.
He makes the sparks fly. He really does. You know, it's like the 4th of July, every time he gets under the center, because he's a make-it-happen guy, and he can look bad on a couple of plays and come right back and knock you out with a big one, just like the pass he threw down there to the 4-yard line. And again, if the Bears don't get better rush on him, he's going to continue to have a good afternoon here throwing a football against what the Bears are using an awful lot this afternoon. Surprisingly so, a zone defense.
Meanwhile, Dennis McKinnon has been the big man for the Bears. But the Bears have dropped some passes to hurt Tomczak. Here is the kickoff. And it's a terrible kick and picked up at the 35 to the 40 and returned to the 45. And rushing with the ball out to midfield, the Bears have it down at the Philadelphia Eagle 44-yard line by Glenn Kozlowski, a wide receiver, and a terrible kickoff by Zendejas.
He looks like he's kicking a cement ball the way he's kicking that thing this afternoon.
So the Bears get into good striking position after a 22-yard return by Kozlowski. He was the number 11 pick out of BYU. And, of course, the best starting position of the day for Chicago. It is Muster in the backfield along with Anderson. Four-man front for the Eagles. Back to throw. Tom Zach, he throws, and it's inside the 35 and caught. Caught by Davis, the wide receiver, and that's a first down to the 33, a 13-yard pickup.
That's what they have to do. They have to throw the ball. They can't be afraid to throw the ball and then go back to the run when they want to or when they feel they have to, but they got to pump the ball up and take advantage of the coverage of the Philadelphia Eagles.
Muster stays in the lineup. He's the up back in the I formation. Anderson the tailback. There's not much grass in the middle of the field where the Bears occupy their position. First down call by Tomczak. Bozo, the tight end in motion. Here's a toss to Anderson coming left. Tried to turn the corner and bumped out at the 30-yard line. He got two. And Todd Bell put on a big hit along the sideline.
Another eight-man front, Jack. Another eight-man front.
And they continue to run into
it. And they keep running it. They want to prove, evidently, that that is a good defense against a run, evidently.
A pickup of three. Anderson has rushed three times, 5 yards. Pickup of two, actually, to the 31. Second and eight. 7-6, the Bears lead. 8:06 left in the half. Bears going from our right to our left here in the second quarter. Morris to the right. Davis to the left. McKinnon not in there at the moment. Nor was he in the last time. Here is a draw play to Muster. Muster is hit right at the line of scrimmage. No gain. And it is going to be third and nine.
Eight-man front again, Jack. Did the same thing. A little high diddle-diddle right up the middle on a draw play.
And Reichenbach made the tackle at the 31. Third down and nine for Chicago, and they didn't make anything thus far of that return by Kozlowski after the bad kick by Zendejas.
It's one thing to have good field position. We've talked about it many times, Jack. Another thing to take advantage of that good field position.
Dennis Gentry is added to the Chicago lineup. And Tom Zach lines up in the shotgun. He needs 9 yards.
Here it is again. Look at everybody in line of scrimmage. You get now they're
here's
backing
back
out.
The throw, and the throw is to the 25. And a first down throw it is to the 15, to the 10, and out of bounds. First and goal, Chicago. The ball taken down by Morris, and Wes Hopkins bumped him out of bounds. Ron Morris for a 27-yard gain and some missed tackles by the Eagles.
That's the great thing about a speed burner like Morris. And that time they showed a man-for-man coverage, Jack, at the last minute switched to his own. And he threw the ball outside on a square out pattern, missed tackles on the outside. Does a great job of running down the sideline. Roynell Young missed the tackle. And he's finally knocked out of bounds right about the 4-yard line.
First and goal. For Chicago, they lead 7-6. Anderson, the tailback in the I formation. Tom Zach calls timeout, and the Bears use a timeout with 6:25 remaining in the half. Let us take timeout.
You like this car for the room, the smooth, controlled ride, the powerful V6 engine, the world-class aerodynamics. It appeals to your more sensible side. But in the end, you have to admit it, the Buick Regal is one very beautiful automobile. You like the way it looks, and you like the looks you get. This Buick is truly regal in every way.
The great American road belongs to Buick.
First and goal for the Bears from the 4, back in a moment.
House calls with Dr. Otis R. Bowen, Secretary of Health and Human Services.
Hello, this is Dr. Bowen. One of the questions I'm asked is, what is AIDS and what are its symptoms? AIDS is a disease caused by a virus which attacks certain cells of the body's immune system and destroys its ability to fight off infection and disease. Some of the early symptoms of AIDS are weight and appetite loss, fever, night sweats, skin rashes, diarrhea, tiredness, lack of resistance to infection, and swollen lymph glands. Later stage symptoms include persistent coughing, fever, shortness of breath, bouts with pneumonia, and a cancer which usually appears as purple blotches on the skin or in the mouth, and confusion or other symptoms of mental disorders. Those with AIDS symptoms or who suspect they are at risk should see their doctor immediately for tests, treatment, and advice. If you have questions about AIDS, call 1-800-342-AIDS.
The ball rests just inside the Philadelphia five-yard line. Later in the broadcast, we'll tell you about today's Chunky Super Lineman, sponsored by Campbell's Chunky Soup. It takes care of the meanest appetites. Later today, Seattle at Cincinnati, 3:45 Eastern Time. You'll hear the game on CBS Radio.
Jack, right now I throw a play-action pass on a right hash mark. I give myself plenty of room, do something with a play-action fake, and I guarantee you, you'll pump it in there for a score.
Morris to the left and Davis to the right. Muster and Anderson are the split backs. Motion by the tight end. Here is a running play to Anderson. Touchdown! He blew right over the left guard spot. It opened up like a flower, Hank.
It really did. Fantastic blocking at the point of attack on the left side. Looked like Covert and Bortz coming off the ball. A beautiful play goes right in there for the touchdown.
And that comes with 6:21 remaining in the half. You have to keep looking back at what the Eagles have done to hurt themselves today. They dropped a pass in the end zone. They had two touchdown passes called back. They just had a terrible kickoff. Here's the extra point tried by Butler. It is up and it is good, and the Bears lead by 8, 14-6, with 6:21 remaining in the half. And to Neil Anderson, for all you do, this bunt's for you. Let's take time out.
The Transamerica Pyramid in San Francisco. The Jones House on Elm Street. They don't seem to have a lot in common. But look closer, and you'll find the Jones House is protected by Transamerica Insurance and Transamerica Title. Their new kitchen was made possible by a home equity loan from Transamerica Financial Services. Even Mr. Jones is covered by a policy from the Transamerica Life Companies, because we believe in keeping up with the Joneses. Transamerica, the power of the pyramid is working for you.
In the NFL, if you're going to be a winner, you have to first learn how to be a survivor. I'm Dave Duerson of the Chicago Bears. And before I played my first ball game in the NFL, I knew that on the field or off, the game of life could be just as tough. That's why I work as a United Way volunteer, to bring the most important messages about life to young people. Today, drugs are destroying our society, but America is fed up. Kids are learning it's more fun to be part of a team than part of a game. And with my team and all the players and coaches of the National Football League, we are winning in the toughest fight of our decade. As partners with the United Way, we're helping young people to understand why and how to say no to drugs. The only time we'll really lose this fight is if we stop trying, stop caring. But with your support of the United Way, we can still win. And I know we will, because the United Way, it brings out the best in all of us.
This message furnished by the National Football League.
Bears just went 45 yards in four plays with a key pass to Morris and a four-yard touchdown run by Neil Anderson. This broadcast presented by authority of the National Football League, intended for the enjoyment of our listening audience. Any rebroadcast or the use of this broadcast without the express written consent of the National Football League and the Chicago Bears is prohibited. The kickoff to Walter Abercrombie or Izell Jenkins from our right to our left, with the Bears leading by 8. The Bears have turned it over twice. There's the kick. It's high, and it's going to be taken from the 7 and returned by Jenkins to the 20, to the 25, to the 30-yard line, and out to the 32. A good return by Izell Jenkins, and Lorenzo Lynch tackled him. 25-yard return. These Eagles have self-destructed today, Hank.
They really have. Another interesting stat, Jack, on the quarterback situation on third down. Today, Cunningham is 1 of 5 on first down, and Tomczak 4 of 6 on third down conversions.
So the Eagles are at their 32 with Tony in the backfield. Three wide receivers. Harder to the right, quick to the left. And back to throw Cunningham. Short drop and the pass caught out to the 45, 47-yard line. And caught by Byers, who was flanked out. And he catches the ball like the best wide receivers in the game.
He really does, and he's taken a lot of pride in the fact that he is catching the ball like he is. He's a great runner. Used to carrying the ball 25 and 30 times a game at Ohio State. I asked him about that. He averages about 9 carries here. He said, it doesn't make any difference. I got to pass the responsibilities down. Now I'm going to be ready to run 25 times next year.
He practiced all offseason with Cunningham in Philadelphia. Quick goes in motion. Cunningham to throw. Short trap, the pass. Caught into Bears territory. Inside the 45 and close to a first down. As Quick was bumped out. An 11-yard pickup. He was in motion, and they didn't stay with him, Hank.
You know, the other thing that's interesting, when you play against a quarterback like Cunningham, you tell your defensive lineman, be under control. Make sure that you stay in your lanes. Make sure you don't let him run. Make sure you don't let him get out of the pocket. Make sure, and as a result, you get a little bit cautious rushing the quarterback. And as a result, aggressive team like the Bears are not rushing nearly as aggressively as we normally see them rush.
Another passing setup for the Eagles with Tony in the backfield. They split Mike Quick out. Cunningham draws the ball to Tony. Tony is tackled at the 38. He got 4 yards on the draw play. Anthony Tony. And it was Dan Hampton on the tackle. Now we have 5:10 left in the half with the Bears on top, 14-6. And at this point, Henry, there's no telling who's going to win this one.
No, it's jump ball. Flip of the coin the way it goes. And again, the turnover ratio, I mentioned that to Tom Sack before the game. And he said, Coach, I guarantee you, if I wouldn't even have to look the scoreboard. If we don't have any turnovers, we're going to win the game. And so they've had two already, but they're still ahead.
Byers goes wide to the left, Carter to the right, along with Quick. Second down and 7 for the Eagles. And another pass play by Cunningham. And he is sacked. He runs. He's hit and knocked down at the 42. Back to he lost 3 yards on the play in the third time they sacked him. Dan Hampton wouldn't let him get away. He darn near got away.
He came close. He sure did.
He is tackled back at the Chicago 42.
And Hampton had two guys blocking him, the center and also the left guard, who was holding on the play. He finally made the tackle after Cunningham started to run with the play up the middle.
It is third down and 10 at the Chicago 42 for Cunningham. He checks the defense and lines up in the shotgun. Takes the snap, back to throw. No pressure over the middle and incomplete. It went off the hands of Mike Quick, who was curling in the middle. And it's fourth down and punting time for Philadelphia. That ball could have been caught, Hank.
Yeah, but the Eagles on third down are 0-for-6.
Dennis McKinnon is back to get the punt, standing at his 10, as Telchik punts for the second time today. The snap by Alexander. It's a good one, and Telchik kicks the ball and hangs it up, and McKinnon lets it go. It bounces at the 10, and it's going to be down inside the 10 at the 7-yard line by Philadelphia. So the Bears have a long way to go. They're back at their 7 with 3:52 left in the half. The Bears have the lead 14-6. And Philadelphia cannot connect on their third down plays.
Well, the problem is, Jack, you know what's happening. On third down, they wind up with an average of 14 yards to go on third down, and that's a tough, tough assignment. You know, the nice situation is wind up with third and 4, third and 5, third and 6, but then you have the option runner pass. But third and 14, you know you're going to throw the ball, and it's tough to get it.
Matt Suey is back in the lineup for the Bears. He was injured earlier. Mike Tomczak, the quarterback at the Chicago 7-yard line. Here the first down snap and a give to Thomas Sanders, trying to slide outside. Cuts back to the 10, to the 15, to the 20, to the 25, 40. He's to midfield. He's into Philadelphia territory and out of bounds at the 34.
What a great seam He saw it quickly, hit it. Roynell Young finally made the tackle, number 43. A beautiful run by Sanders.
59 yards from his own 7 to the Philadelphia 35. That's where they mark it down. Roynell Young finally made the tackle, but only because he had an angle on Sanders, who broke loose. Some good downfield blocking by the Bears. There were no flags, and finally Roynell Young, along with Eric Allen, caught up with him. And the Bears have called another timeout.
And Todd Bell, number 52, had a chance at him, Jack, but wasn't able to make the play.
It's the second Bears timeout in the first half. Let's pause for this word.
Do I hear five? Five? 5,000 to the coffer.
No, I was...
7, thank you, sir.
Hey, buddy, you better get a cough syrup or you're going to go broke.
Better yet, here, try a Vicks Throat Drop with instant action. Its medicine works on contact, so you'll get cough relief. You know, like a cough syrup, only faster.
Sold! 10,000 to the lady waving a box of Vicks Throat Drops.
What?
Gee, thanks. Get instant action. Get a Vicks Throat Drop. Use as directed. And for those other times when you need extra vitamin C, try a Vicks Vitamin C Drop.
Gary's asleep. If you think this is a lousy way to ring in the new year, just wait. He's getting rested to take me to Sears' gigantic, spectacular New Year's Day sale. All men's, women's, and children's apparel, even new merchandise is 15 to 50% off. Famous Sears brands like Goolagong and McKids. There are Levi's, too. It's only on Sunday and Monday, so rest up, and you'll have plenty to celebrate in the morning.
What was that?
Sears, your money's worth it.
Go first and 10 at the Philadelphia 35. They try to add to their 8-point lead. Anderson, the tailback, in the eye. The give to fake to him and a pass play. Long down the left sideline and overthrown and incomplete. And a mix-up on that play as they try to get it downfield to Cap Bozo, who is not the best of receivers as a tight end. They really miss Emory Moorhead on the Chicago team.
I think with the way the coverage is, I think they tried to take advantage possibly of a mismatch. But again, Tomczak had a lot of pressure right up the middle and got rid of the ball nicely, or else it had been a sack.
Tomczak is 7 out of 14, 156 yards, one touchdown pass to McKinnon, one intercepted, that by Joyner of the Eagles. Second and 10 for the Bears. High formation with Suey, the upback.
Here's that 8-man front, Jack.
Motion by McKinnon. Here is the quarterback back to throw over the middle, and it's caught inside the 30, down near the 27-yard line, bringing about third and about 3 as the pass was caught by McKinnon, and Reggie White made the tackle. That's one of the few times we mentioned his name today.
Yeah, he hasn't been able to get much of a pass rush at all, and Van Horn, number 78, to right tackle, has done a good job of containing him on the line of scrimmage, and he hasn't been able to get to the quarterback.
Here is a crucial third down. It's third and a long two. It's third and 3, actually, at the 33-yard line of Philadelphia. Let's see how Tomczak tries to get the first down. Motion by the tight end. Here's the running play to Anderson. Inside, outside, and in trouble. And tackle for a loss on the play. Back at the 28 by Eric Allen, the cornerback. And now that hurts the field goal position of the Bears. They bring Kevin Butler onto the field.
Todd Bell came up there in good shape and made the play, too. Number 52.
This will be a long field goal try by Kevin Butler. He tried one earlier of 52 yards and missed it. This will be a 46-yard attempt. His longest of the year is 45. So this will be his longest of the year. Wagner holding. There's the kick. And it is going to be good. It just made it over. Kevin Butler gets 3 more points for the Bears. It took the paint off the other side of the crossbar.
That's exactly what it did. It scraped it on the backside going down, Jack. That's exactly what it did.
An 11-point lead now for Chicago, 17-6. And let's pause for this word.
Football fans, get ready for the battle of the century. As unbeaten Budweiser takes on undefeated Bud Light. It's Bud versus Bud Light in Bud Bowl 1. Pick up your official Bud Bowl scorecard wherever you buy Budweiser or Bud Light. Then use it to follow all the hard-hitting action. So get ready. Get set. On February 22nd, Bud Bowl 1. This time, it's for real. Void where prohibited, no purchase necessary. Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
Chopper 1 to Tower.
This is Tower.
Unit sighted, proceeding to Phase 2 of Operation Airlift. That wraps up our weekend training.
Roger, Chopper 1.
Get a change of pace without changing your lifestyle. Join the Army Reserve. After training, you usually serve 1 weekend a month and 2 weeks a year. But the experience lasts a lifetime. Talk to your Army Reserve recruiter.
Be all that you can be. Find your future in the Army Reserve.
Paid for by the Army Reserve.
Hank, the Bears are kind of killing the Eagles softly, aren't they?
They really are, and of course, the Eagles are killing themselves.
Here's the kickoff, and it bounces inside the 15. Jenkins took it on the 4, back to the 10. He's to the 15 and knocked down short of the 20-yard line. And he was tackled downfield by Dante Jones, one of the Chicago linebackers. The Philadelphia 18-yard line. Total offense, the Eagles 161 yards and the Bears 239, and the Bears have made some big plays. 64-yard touchdown pass and a long pass to Morris to set up a touchdown. A long run by Sanders would set up the field goal. So the big plays have hurt the Eagles, and the Eagles have hurt themselves. They've missed a field goal. They dropped a pass in the end zone. They had two touchdown passes called back on the same series because of penalties. They had a terrible kickoff that led to a Chicago touchdown. All of that has conspired to see them trail 17-6.
The really thing that really hurt them a lot was the fact that Keith Jackson dropped that one wide open in the end zone for the touchdown.
Now this is the Bears' worst starting position. We have the two-minute warning. 1:52 remaining in the half. Let's pause for this word.
We get up every morning from the alarm clock's warning. Take the first step, turn into the city. We'll pick your shipment up with care. We'll take it anywhere from Milan to Seoul, Kansas City.
When it comes to shipping by air, nobody's more experienced or delivers more freight to more cities around the world than Flying Tigers. That's why it's no surprise our international distribution service is the fastest way to ship virtually anything from overseas. IDS gives you next day delivery from Asia and Europe to the U.S. So for next day delivery around the world or across the country, call Flying Tigers because
we're taking care of business.
Sudden heavy fog has rolled in. Cunningham back to throw. He throws out in the flat, caught beyond the 25-yard line by Keith Byers. And an 11-yard pickup and a hurry-up offense for Philadelphia from their own 29. First down for the Eagles. Out of heavy, heavy fog. Cunningham to throw again. He is chased out of the pocket. He throws on the run and is wide open to Jackson. To the 20-yard line, he might score. He's out of bounds at the 6. Down at the 5-yard line. And the Eagles come striking back, a 66-yard pass play over Todd Crum, caught by Keith Jackson. And the Eagles call timeout.
Look at this fog, Jack. You can hardly see the players.
It's come in a big hurry. What a big pass play to Jackson. How did he get so free, Hank?
He went right down the hash marks, it looked like. Had to be a zone defense, two people covering, short and long. He uses a good straight arm and almost got free and into the end zone for the touchdown.
He is down to the Chicago 6-yard line. And now the fog has enveloped this field. You wouldn't believe how quickly it rolled in and how dense it is.
You got to put the windshield wipers on, Jack.
It is very difficult to see the players from the seats right now.
I can't even see you, Jack. Where are you?
I've got the binoculars here. I don't know if I'll be able to tell you what the heck happens when the Philadelphia Eagles snapped the ball from the Chicago 6-yard line. They may have to hold things up here. That's how bad it is. And it's still rolling in. And there's plenty of it out there on Lake Michigan. I'm telling you, you can't see bananas out there. But the Eagles get under center with Cunningham. They're trailing 17-6. Cunningham is going to throw. He throws into the end zone. And it is incomplete as they try to get it to Mike Quick. They try to get the ball to Mike Quick. And now we can't see how much time is left because we can't read the scoreboard from here. And it's second and goal from the 5-yard line. Tony is in the backfield. And Cunningham gets under center. Mike Quick is on a wing. Cunningham rolling right and throwing. And the ball is into the end zone and caught for.
Looks like it's just short.
Just short. Out of bounds at the 1-yard line. Caught by Anthony Tony. But a flag has been thrown. And the Eagles have done it to themselves. Referee Jim Tunney is going to mark off some more yards. The ball is at the 5. It was caught by Tony. He was bumped out of bounds right at the goal line. And an offensive pass interference call against Philadelphia.
Pass interference. Offense, number 84, is 10 yards and still second down.
The call was against Kenny Jackson. It's a 10-yard penalty back to the 15-yard line. And it's second and goal. Fifth penalty against the Eagles. Ball at the Chicago 15.
Yeah, he pushed off with a left hand that time on Richardson.
Carter comes to the right. Quick is to the left. Cunningham under center. Heavy fog on this playing field. Crowd noise bothering Cunningham is back to throw. He steps up and he throws the ball short. It's caught and the tackle is made at the 14-yard line. Tony caught the ball and it's third down. Let's pause 10 seconds. The fog is starting to lift for stations to identify themselves on the CBS Radio Network.
You want more than just the scores? Come by Cairns, and I've got them for you every weekday morning right here on your sports leader in the Capital District, WQBK-Rensselaer, Albany, Schenectady, Troy.
They put the ball down at the Chicago 13-yard line, and it is going to be third and goal. And a timeout called by the Eagles. And we still don't know how much time is left. It's very difficult to read the clock, although the fog has started to lift somewhat. I would guess there's about a minute left and a half, Hank.
Yeah, I think that's about right, Jack. And it's amazing how it came in, talking about the fog, and now how it's lifting. And, you know, talking about the field, they used 8 million BTUs on this field yesterday to thaw out the turf and get it ready for this game. Can you imagine that? 8 million BTUs.
44 seconds remaining in the half. And it's third and goal at the 13 for the Eagles. Carter to the right. Tight end Jackson on the right side. Byers is split out. Four-man front for Chicago. The blitz is on. Cunningham throws. Incomplete to Chris Carter in the end zone. And it's fourth down. The Eagles will have to settle for a field goal try. He tried to get it to Carter, but nothing doing. And on third down, Cunningham is 0 for 7. Here's Zendejas. He has made one, and he has missed one today. In fact, he's made two. This is a 30-yard try. Ball held by Telchik. Still heavy. There's the kick. Nobody knows. The kick is good. With the fog here, we couldn't see it go through, but that makes it 17-10 with about 40 seconds. 17-9 with about 40 seconds left in the half. The Bears lead by 8. Let's pause for this word.
The sound of football, translated by Campbell's Chunky Soup.
I'm so hungry I could tear your head off. Brunsky better not have eaten that last can of Chunky or I'll get him. My stomach growls one more time in this defensive donkey's history. Thinking about those tender chunks of chicken and beef in Chunky makes me crazy. Sorry to run you into the ground, but it's time for some Chunky.
Campbell's Chunky Soup. It takes care of the meanest appetites.
Introducing Riata, Buick's premium American two-seater. Sports car style without sports car pain, says Car and Driver. We savored every minute in the Riata saddle, says Automobile. Buick revives the American driver's car, says Auto Week. Riata by Buick. If your destination in life has always been the top, go ahead. You deserve it.
Temperature drops here at Soldier Field, Chicago, as the fog rolls in heavily again. The temperature was 29 degrees at game time. So the Eagles gather their third field goal, 42 yards, 29 yards, and this time 30 yards by Luis Sendejas. And the Bears lead by 8. And here is the kickoff, and the Bears pick it up and come out to the 25-yard line. Tackles are missed, and the play comes across the 30. Thomas Sanders returned the ball. With only a few seconds left in the half, and the Bears will probably just sit on it and enjoy their 8-point lead at the half as Mike Tomczak goes back in. Captain Meyer, the Eagles, the way they came back, got those 3 points.
Well, you know, the one thing about the Eagles team, they're not going to roll over and play dead. They're a very dog-minded team as far as perseverance is concerned, and they've been able to come back all year long. They've done a great job in the third and fourth quarters.
Tomczak is under center. The ball is at his 33-yard line, and now from the shotgun, he's back to throw. He throws, and it's intercepted. And back the other way comes Todd Bell, the former Bears player. He is tackled. And now the Eagles have the ball again. That's a third turnover by Chicago. Hank, I thought they'd just sit on the ball and enjoy the lead.
I did, too. I thought, sure, they'd stick an ice pick in it. And go in at halftime satisfied with what the score is right now. Now they provide him with an opportunity to get something on the board again before halftime.
The ball was caught, intercepted out around midfield by Todd Bell. He returned it a few yards. And it's a first down for Philadelphia. And we have to watch the television monitor. 19 seconds left in the half. Cunningham is back to throw. He looks and throws over the middle, and it's caught by Keith Jackson. And he is down inside the 30-yard line. And another timeout is used by Philadelphia. So it could be the Eagles are going to get some more points and dig in on that lead, which a while ago was 11 points for the Chicago Bears. After Kevin Butler kicked a field goal with 2:03 left in the half. Later today, Seattle at Cincinnati. Brad Sham and Randy Rasmussen are there. 3:45 Eastern Time is broadcast time on CBS Radio. And we shall have both games for you tomorrow. 23 seconds remaining in the half after the pass to Jackson. Well, there's a number one draft pick out of Oklahoma, Keith Jackson, who said... Now they say only 9 seconds left in the half. He said he was going to be on the Pro Bowl, Hank, and there he is. He's caught 4 today.
You know what he was talking about? He's a delightful guy to talk to. And he said the reason he's having such a great year is the fact that Quick was out earlier in the year, and as a result, they caught a lot more passes than he normally would have caught had Quick been in the contest.
The ball is inside the Bears' 30 at the 22. Chicago 22-yard line, and Cunningham's going to throw another pass. 9 seconds left in the half. He's back to throw and looks and throws. He throws, and it's dropped and almost intercepted by Chicago. And, in fact, it was by Pruitt, the linebacker. He intercepts with 2 seconds left in the half, and Philadelphia blows another 3 points, Hank.
The only thing about this thing so far from a positive standpoint, I'm talking about Philadelphia, what Buddy Ryan's going to say at halftime. He said, listen, we're behind in this game, but But we're behind only because of what we did to ourselves, not what the Chicago Bears did to us. So we just got to eliminate the mistakes in the second half and come back and play like we're supposed to play, and we'll be back in business.
That's the first turnover by the Eagles in the first half, an interception by Pruitt. Mickey Pruitt picked it off. He's a rookie out of Colorado. And now one more snap of the ball, and we shall have our 17-9 score here at the half. The Bears just sit on it, as I thought they would do a moment ago. And at the half in this NFC divisional playoff game, foggy feel, worse than ever now here at Soldier Field. The Bears lead 17-9. Let's pause for this word.
We get up every morning from the alarm clock's warning. Take the first step, turn into the city. We'll pick your shipment up with care. We'll take it anywhere from Milan to Seoul, Kansas City.
When it comes to shipping by air, nobody's more experienced or delivers more freight to more cities around the world than Flying Tigers. That's why it's no surprise our international distribution service is the fastest way to ship virtually anything from overseas. IDS gives you next day delivery from Asia and Europe to the U.S. So for next day delivery around the world or across the country, call Flying Tigers, because
we're taking care of business.
I'm Joe Isuzu. Ever wonder what a Jeep Cherokee owner says when he finds out the Isuzu Trooper comes with a 5-speed transmission, power steering, skid plates, carpeting, opening side windows, and reclining front seats, all standard? Or what a Jeep Cherokee owner says when he learns that a comparably equipped base Isuzu Trooper costs over $1,000 less? You can say that again.
Now for a limited time, get a $750 factory cash rebate on the Isuzu Trooper.
Alpha 6, this is Alpha 1.
This is Alpha 6.
We did it again. We captured Bravo's command post.
Second day in a row. You guys had a pretty good weekend.
Get a change of pace without changing your lifestyle. Join the Army Reserve. After training, you usually serve 1 weekend a month and 2 weeks a year. But the experience lasts a lifetime. Talk to your Army Reserve recruiter. Paid for by the Army Reserve.
It was a 10-point second quarter for the Bears, which finds them on top now by the score of 17-9. A 64-yard touchdown pass to Dennis McKinnon, the first points of the game. After Zendejas missed from 43 yards, he hit from 42 yards. Then a 4-yard run by Neil Anderson. A 46-yard field goal by Kevin Butler made it 17-9 as Zendejas kicked a 30-yard field goal for the final points of the first half. Randall Cunningham is 13 out of 24 with one intercepted, and Tomczak is 8 out of 16 with one touchdown pass and two intercepted. 17-9 Chicago at the half, and we turn things over to Brent Musburger.
All right, Jack, thank you very much. This has been a game of missed opportunities on the part of the Philadelphia Eagles. Dick Butkus is here. We'll talk to him, and right now let's pause for this word.
My friends, I say to you, bountiful are the rewards for convincing your company to get a Bex by Toshiba.
You will rise through the ranks, and your boss will give thanks for the wonderful things Bex simply brings to the business at hand.
Yes, truer words were never spoken, for what can put a glint in the eye and a smile on the lips of a poker-faced boss faster than a machine that can send words and pictures over ordinary phone lines in as little as 15 seconds? What can loosen the purse strings of his heart better than a machine that can spare him the agony of high phone and courier bills? Dear friends, the key to the executive washroom is but a Toshiba facsimile away. We'll put you in touch with tomorrow. Take away business headaches and sorrow.
Toshiba, Toshiba facsimile. So good for your company.
For a free demonstration or more information about Toshiba facsimile systems, call 1-800-635-1220.
Well, Dick Beckus, you were out on the field as the Philadelphia Eagles misfired when they got down there in scoring range. Do you think they're young, the jitters, or how did you look at it?
No, I think those penalties really hurt them. They got caught a couple offsides, or a couple holding plays and stuff like that. I don't think they're jittery. I mean, Cunningham's amazing to me is that he's just cool and calm and just marching down the field. And when he, you know, I was on that one sideline where they were scoring all the time or trying to score. I mean, he was cool and, you know, looked fully in control.
You know, Dick, Dennis McKinnon was wide open on that long touchdown pass for Mike Tomczak.
Well, I think that's what Coach Greg Landry was talking about earlier before the game about Tomczak. If he can just remain patient, they couldn't get a real feel as to what the Eagles' defense was going to do because the last few games they were using man-to-man. Before that, they were using zone, so they mixed it up pretty good. And he was hoping that Tomczak would just be patient enough because, you know, they feel that, you know, he could throw deep very well and just look for the open man. And that time there was a breakdown back.
We haven't seen much of Neil Anderson. Perhaps that injury a little more serious than we believe.
I think that groin is, you know, he's like a thoroughbred, you know? I mean, there's some backs who are tough and can run with injuries and everything else, but this guy's such a pure runner that I think any little injury bothers him, and I don't think he can recover as fast.
You made the point in our pregame show on television that Kevin Butler had changed his left shoe to give him a little more footing. When Luis Zendejas missed his first one, was he sliding at all on his left shoe?
I don't think so. I think it was just a matter of being short. Maybe he didn't hit it well. And then when Kevin Butler tried the long one, I mean, it just sounded like a rat. I mean, you know, when it gets cold, the ball, it's tough to make those long field goals. But I think there's no problem with the field. It's fine.
Should be a wide-open second half here in Soldier Field, and we'll be back in just a moment.
This is Howard Lasher for Lyric Bird Food. Our wintering birds have few options when it comes to coping with winter weather here in the Northeast. They do take advantage of protective cover, especially for roosting. A bird must maintain a higher internal temperature than we do, normally about 106 degrees. This temperature is generated from the seeds they consume. They must have a constant supply of high-quality food available at all times. This is why you'll find generous supplies of high oil seeds such as sunflower, Niagara seed, and peanut hearts in Lyric Blend. A large bird such as a hawk may be able to survive several days without eating, but under the same conditions, a chickadee must eat well every day or would not survive the night. Don't take a chance with our winter birds. Feed them Lyric Supreme. Pick it up where you see the Lyric banner.
Available at Fettigan's Nursery, 1140 Troy Road, Latham, phone 785-6726, and at Rosano's Hardware, 1245 Central Avenue, Albany.
Well, later this afternoon, the Bengals host the Seahawks in an AFC divisional playoff. What a turnaround year this was for the Bengals. They were 4-11 last year, 12-4 this year. They won a divisional title. Let's get more now on the Bengals' resurgence from Tim Moreland of WCKY in Cincinnati.
Brett, a year ago this holiday season, it was in vogue around here to tell a good Sam Weitz joke at a party. But now at 12-4, Central Division champs and one of the favorites to win the Super Bowl, Sam and his Bengals are back in good graces. No more jokes. Everyone else has an answer for the dramatic turnaround from 4-11, so why not the coach?
Well, I wish I had some magic answer because it would be saleable. We could make some money on this thing, but basically it goes back to some fundamental things that are pretty dull, actually, to answer as an answer, and that is the guys came in great shape. They worked hard in the offseason. They had a tremendous attitude. They were always looking ahead, always thinking positive thoughts. They weren't dwelling on what had happened to them the year before. And as the season went along and one win bled into another win, the guys finally realized that all those things do work.
Sam, it's amazing how quickly a guy can get smart in this league, isn't it?
Well, it's smart because the scoreboard says it's smart. You know, fans are... the only way they really read the progress of a team or the competency of a coach is the scoreboard, and the score might be 45-42, and if you won, you've got all the offensive and defensive answers, and if the score is 3-0 and you won, you've got the answers. But let it go the other way and you're just not up to par.
White wants to capitalize on his newfound popularity, not however for himself.
My plea is this: I'll speak at your banquet, I'll be your after-dinner speaker, and the fee of $5,000 will go to a fund for the homeless here in Cincinnati. Every dollar dollar going to that. And I'd love to do some of the speaking in Seattle and Buffalo and Houston and other cities around the country.
Just call the Bengals offices to answer Sam's plea. Not only is he a good speaker, but the coach is a first-rate magician. Rented a few hours, Weich and the Bengals will either be in the AFC title game or in the role of spectators, and that's the point of emphasis this week around Bengal land. Sam's trying to get across to his team that it is the one-strike league. You can play a good game, make one mistake, and be through.
Tim, thank you. And right now, let's pause for this word.
Hi, Joe Isuzu here. Know what a Toyota truck owner says when he finds out the Isuzu pickup has more standard features? Ooh, he's angry. Or what a Nissan truck owner says when you tell him the Isuzu pickup has a larger payload, even though Isuzu's one of the lowest-priced trucks in America? Boy, am I glad I didn't tell him that you can get a $500 factory cash rebate on the Isuzu pickup. That's it. Let go of your anger.
The sound of football, translated by Campbell's Chunky Soup.
I'm so hungry I could tear your head off. Brunsky better not have eaten that last can of Chunky or I'll get him. My stomach growls one more time in this defensive donkey's history. Thinking about those tender chunks of chicken and beef in Chunky makes me crazy. Sorry to run you into the ground, but it's time for some Chunky.
Campbell's Chunky Soup. It takes care of the meanest appetites.
Time now for the second half. Chicago and Philadelphia. Let's go back upstairs, and here's Jack Buck.
We're back here in Chicago. The fog has enveloped the field. Apparently, for the players, it's a good deal easier for them to see the ball than it is for any of the spectators and for the coaches up here in the press box level. So the only thing saving us, Hank Stram, is the ability to watch television and try to do a play-by-play off of that.
And it's even difficult to do it with a television set, Jack, really.
Hank, how about the things that Philadelphia has done wrong today? They missed a field goal. They had two touchdowns called back because of penalties on the same series. They had a touchdown pass dropped in the end zone. They had an interception that denied them another 3 points right at the end of the first half. And they failed to pick up the first down on fourth down inside the five-yard line. Plus the penalties they've had.
Yeah, it's hard to remember when in a big game one team has made so many serious mistakes, as has the Philadelphia Eagles. But the only consoling thing about it is the fact that, you know, if you're the coach, you got to sell them on the idea, listen, we had chances. We just have to bear down and concentrate harder, execute better, and we'll get back right back in this game.
And not only consoling, Hank, but if you had to answer the question, which team looks the better of the two, it'd be difficult to answer.
You're right. Exactly right.
The Eagles look just as good as Chicago in this game. But the Bears have the lead at the half by the score of 17-9, and gratefully the fog is starting to lift a bit after it rolled in off of Lake Michigan, and we'll be back in just a moment.
Celebrate New Year's at Macy's on the 1st and on the 2nd with 20 to 50% savings store-wide. Fashion, housewares, jewelry, electronics, and more. What a spectacular way to ring in the new year. It's 2 days of celebration. 2 days of selected 20 to 50% savings. Sunday and Monday with special shopping hours 10 a.m. till 8 p.m. on New Year's Day.
Your damn hands off!
20 minutes ago, his homeless man had his coat stolen and his last shred of dignity stripped right off his back.
Give me back my coat!
Where do you go when your world is this cold, this cruel? He got help at the Salvation Army. They got help from the United Way. Thank God the United Way got help from you. The United Way. It brings out the best in all of us. A public service of the Advertising Council.
Every once in a while, it appears that the fog is going to drift away, and it lifts a bit, but not only has the fog rolled back in, but the temperature started to drop considerably here in Chicago.
And make sure you stay close to me, Jack. I can't see. I want to make sure I can feel you.
I can't see bananas out there, man. If it weren't for the television monitor, we wouldn't be able to call the play for you. I wonder how the conditions are in Cincinnati for the Seattle game later. That game at 3:45 Eastern on CBS Radio with Brad Sham and Randy Rasmussen, and then those two will be in Buffalo for the Houston game tomorrow. They have the early game. It starts at 12:45 Eastern time tomorrow. with Brent Musburger's pregame show. And Hank and I go out to San Francisco. We get some pretty good fog training here today.
I just hope we can get out.
Oh, I forgot about that. 17-9, the score, and the Bears are on top. But, Hank, they are far from locked up as a winner in this one.
Now, the way this game is going in, the firepower of the Philadelphia Eagles, if they could just stop from killing themselves, why, they're very much in this contest.
They sure got some wide receivers and tight ends open in the latter portion of that first half.
Well, that's the thing that makes them so tough, Jack, is the fact that they have a great tight end. So it's hard to just double cover the outside receivers and cover the tight end with a linebacker. You've got to play football and make sure that you cover all three people. And, of course, the Bears have done a good job of that by using an awful lot of zone defense.
We still haven't seen much running on the part of Cunningham.
No, we haven't. They're very, very concerned about him, and that's why I don't think they've sacked him any more than they have.
Well, three times.
Yeah, they sacked him three times, but again, one time he started a run. That was considered a sack, but I think basically the Bears are very concerned and very cautious with a rush because they don't want to get caught in that kind of a game with him running all over the place.
Hank, we talked about the wide receivers and the proficient tight end of the Eagles. How about Keith Byers catching the ball? He caught 72 during the season. He's caught 4 today.
Well, here again, when the two leading receivers are the tight end with 72 catches, I think that's what he came into the game with.
81 for the tight end and 72 for Byers.
Yeah, and 72, why, it changes. Normally you double cover the outside receivers. Now you have to be concerned about double covering the tight end sometimes and also the halfback coming out of the backfield.
I wonder how it is down on the playing field with regard to those players being able to follow the ball.
Well, I don't know.
Apparently better than we would think.
You might have to put a miner's cap on all those helmets to make those players see where they're going.
Before the Bears kick it off, from our left to our right to start the second half, Bears on top 17-9. Let's pause 10 seconds for stations to identify themselves on the CBS Radio Network.
Sports Talk, Monday through Friday from 5:40 till 7 p.m., as well as sports commentaries at 8:25 and 5:20. Right here at your sports leader, WQBK-Rensselaer, Albany, Schenectady, and Troy.
The Chicago Bears will kick it off to start the second half of this NFC divisional playoff game. And the NFC championship game will be played next weekend. All eight teams remaining in the quest for the Super Bowl are in action this weekend. And the kickoff will come from Butler. It goes down inside the 15-yard line, and it's returned by Jenkins. And Jenkins is tackled after coming across the 20-yard line, I think it is. It's at the 22. At the 32. So Philadelphia starts from their own 32-yard line, and they trail by 8. Only one penalty against the Bears in the first half, and 5 against Philadelphia. 3 turnovers by the Bears, 2 on interceptions, and 1 pass intercepted against Cunningham.
And the rushing yard thing is very deceptive in that Sanders ran for 50-some yards on that big run that made the difference in the yardage rushing-wise.
The Bears have had big plays to find them on top. Cunningham is under center. Will he continue to throw the ball? Yep, he's back to throw on first down. He drops it short, and it's caught across the 40-yard line by Keith Byers. That's some combination. That's his fifth today. And Morrissey and Singletary were there for the tackle.
And a lot of times people say, well, how do you double cover a running back? You cover him inside, outside. Linebacker inside has the inside moves, and the outside linebacker has the outside moves, and they try to put him in a squeeze between the two of them, and that's how they cover double coverage.
There's a 5-yard pickup to the 37 of Philadelphia. Second down and 7, and the running play by Byers this time. And he is out near the 40-yard line. That's a first down. So Byers ran it out for a first down for Philadelphia up to the 50. Eagles certainly show the ability to move this ball.
Oh, yeah, they're exciting. They make a lot of things happen. As I mentioned to you, Jack, they've been very good in the third and fourth quarters.
With Alexander and Baker the guards, Heller and Darwin the tackles, Remington the center is over the ball. Now play is halted for a moment by the official to get things squared away.
This reminds me a little bit, Jack, of the last college All-Star game that was played here. Remember that?
Reset the 30.
They're having a little bit of difficulty with the 30-second clock.
Reset the 30, please. We will keep the 30 and 45-second clock on the field. The field judge will time the 30 and 45-second clock.
No, because of the fog here, the field judge is going to have to do the timing. With it all, the Bears lead by 8, 17-9. Cunningham gets under center. Visibility not bad down on the playing surface. Cunningham back to throw. He throws over the middle, and a diving catch is good by Mike Quick, and that's another first down. 13-yard pickup to Mike Quick. And they just can't stop the Philadelphia passing attack except on third down, Hank.
Well, Quick, you know, missed some games during the course of the season, came back, has only caught 22 passes, but he's averaging 23.1 on every reception, which is very strong and typical of the kind of skill and ability he has.
That pass play carried down to the Chicago 38-yard line, and another first down for the Eagles, who took the second half kickoff and are on the move. Back to throw and over the middle, and this one is caught as well. This one by Keith Jackson, the tight end. And he is down near the 30-yard line.
Those receivers are just going downfield and breaking into the open area, hooking into the open area because the linebackers are coming back, defensive backs are going back deep, and they're throwing strikes against that zone coverage.
Another first down. A ball at the Chicago 25 and a first down for Philadelphia, and Cunningham to throw again. A short drop out in the flat, and it's knocked down. Knocked down by Harris. That's the second one he has batted down today. And it's second down and 10 for the Eagles. I'm telling you, these fans here in the stands, 66,000 of them, don't have the benefit of the television set that we have, and they can't see a darn thing out there. I mean, the fog is more dense now than it was before. The only thing it hasn't done is settle down to the surface of the playing field. Second down and 10 for the Eagles. Under center, Cunningham back to throw. Short drop again, over the middle again, caught by Byers again and brought down for a gain of 5 or 6 or 7. He's just taking that short drop, Hank, and they can't get to him.
Well, you see, Singletary and Morrissey, 50 and 51 respectively, both of them right around the ball, which means they're trying to cover him with two people, and he's still catching the ball between them.
It is second down and 4, the ball at the Bears 19. Keep waiting for one of the linebackers to step in front of one of those passes, but it's hard to do.
And they're not getting much pressure at all.
It's third down for Cunningham. He changes the play at the line of scrimmage, gets under center, rolls right and throws the ball, drops it off, and it is caught. And the tackle is made from behind on Anthony Toney. And let's see what kind of forward progress he got on that one. He's spreading the ball around to Quick, Jackson, Byers, Toney. They're all taking them down. That was a third down play. And let's see where they have marked it.
And you keep seeing Morrissey and Singletary surface after those catches are being made.
The ball is at the Chicago 12, and it's a first down. And Cunningham really moving him. Back to throw, chased out of the pocket this time, rolls right and throws on the run. The pass is into the end zone and incomplete. He tried to get it downfield to Chris Carter. And it's second down and 10 at the 12. Hank, do you share my opinion that the Eagles are moving the ball much better today than the Bears are moving?
Well, they're consistently moving it well. They have good sustained drives, doing a good job with their passing game. The only problem is they've had a lot of mistakes when the time came to go in and score a touchdown.
Cunningham is 18 out of 31 for 300 yards, one intercepted. He hasn't been able to throw a touchdown pass yet. He is camped at the Chicago 12, and it's second and 10. Ninth play of the drive coming up here at the outset of the second half. Cunningham directing traffic, gets under center, some big rush is on, he rolls and throws, and it's bobbled and intercepted, back the other way, off the hands of Toney, and intercepted by Vesty Jackson. He's down the sideline for a good return, and out of bounds he goes, down into Philadelphia territory. Every time the Eagles get close, something bad happens.
It's amazing. It's just amazing that that many bad things could happen to one team in this kind of a championship game.
And Jackson took it off the hands of Tony, and the Eagles are stymied again. And now Chicago has the ball near midfield. Let's take time out.
We get up every morning from the alarm clocks. When we take the first step, turn into the city. We'll pick your shipping up with care. We'll take it anywhere from Milan to Seoul to Kansas City.
Need something shipped internationally fast? Well, there's good news in the air. Flying Tigers International Distribution Service. IDS gives you next day delivery from Asia and Europe to the U.S. And with no size or weight restrictions, you're not limited to just envelopes and small packages. So whether you're shipping from Tokyo to Tampa, Dusseldorf to Dallas, or just Seattle to San Francisco, call Flying Tigers because
we're taking care of business.
The 1988 NBA Championships, the 1988 Super Bowl, the Democratic Convention. These were some of the most intensely covered media events in the world. But perhaps their most important coverage came from one very unique building in San Francisco, the Transamerica Pyramid. Because every one of these events was insured by Transamerica Insurance. And if we could protect them, imagine what we could do for you, your family, or business. Transamerica, the power of the pyramid is working for you.
Tony of the Eagles gobbled the ball. He was the pass receiver. Went off his hands into the hands of Vesty Jackson, who returned it 52 yards down to the Philadelphia 40-yard line. That was the ninth interception by Vesty Jackson this year, Henry.
You know, as I mentioned, you know, people attack him so many times now because they stay away from the other side, Richardson. He's getting better and better all the time. Another thing with this kind of a game, Jack, the communication between the coaches in the booth and the coaches on the sideline is almost nil because the coaches up here can't see, plus the fact they can't use their Polaroid pictures.
CBS Radio Sports coverage of the National Football League is sponsored by Flying Tigers, by Transamerica, by Isuzu, and by new maximum strength Pepto-Bismol. 10:20 left in the third quarter. Under center, Mike Tomczak at the Philadelphia 40-yard line. He has Anderson in the backfield with him. Bears get the ball for the first time in the second half. Motion by the tight end and a toss to Anderson running left. Turns the corner a little bit and gets some yards before he's chased out of bounds. Neil Anderson picks up some yards as they turn the corner. Another 10-yard gain. Anderson down to the Philadelphia 30.
They were very concerned about Anderson coming into the game because of the groin problem, but it doesn't look like it's bothered him at all so far in this game.
He has a touchdown run. In addition, McKinnon scored a touchdown and Butler a field goal for the Bears. First down at the 30. Pass play over the middle. And this one is hauled in by the tight end, Cap Bozo. He got some yards, 7 yards. Down to the 23. So they just did what the Eagles have been doing all day, that little pop pass over the middle.
The only difference is, really, that the Bears have taken advantage of field opportunity when the Eagles have not.
The Eagles have made all kinds of mistakes today. They should be ahead in this game. Tomczak is under center on 2nd and 3. He starts the tight end in motion again and tosses to Anderson, and there's a reverse, and back the other way, Dennis Gentry. He's down to the 20-yard line and inside the 20. And that's going to be a first down for Chicago on the reverse to Dennis Gentry, who came out of the fog for a 5-yard pickup.
He really did, and that's a good play because once your pursuit is going in one direction, the misdirection of the reverse was very effective.
At the Philadelphia 19, a first down for Chicago. Well, if the Bears continue to move, they'll add to their 8-point advantage. Now they're down to the Philadelphia 19 with Tomczak, the quarterback. Tight end is on the left side. Tomczak hands it off, and the tailback, Anderson, got about a yard before he was blasted back, trying to follow Mark Bortz, the left guard. Very little gain on that one.
You know, it's very interesting, too. The Reggie White's a great player that he is. We haven't had occasion to mention, talk about him hardly at all here this afternoon, except on one occasion where he got a sack.
Heath Van Horn, who did not play in the last game for the Bears, is matched up against White, although he moves around and plays the end and the nose guard and other positions along the defensive line. Second down and 8 for the Bears. They're now at the 17. Tomczak awaits the snap from Hilgenberg. Takes the snap, and he's back to throw. He throws out in the flat, and it's incomplete. And almost intercepted. He tried to get it to Thornton. Apparently, these fans can see a lot of the action, those down close to the playing level. Wes Hopkins was covering, and they thought there was interference on the play. It was incomplete. It's a third down and 8 coming up for the Bears. The Bears are 4 out of 7 on third down today.
I don't know how the kickers, when they kick a field goal, how do they know where the goalposts are? With the fog the way it is, you don't read.
Straight ahead. Here's a third down play for Chicago. First time they've had the ball here in the second half. Tomczak in the shotgun takes the snap. Back to throw. Swings it out in the flat to Gentry. And he lost his footing and went down before he was tackled at the 14-yard line. Gentry tried to juke the defender and lost his footing.
Yeah, Jenkins was the tackler, and in the process of trying to get by him, well, he did lose his footing and didn't make nearly as much yardage as I thought he would once he broke into that area.
It's a fourth down play, and Kevin Butler goes onto the field for a 31-yard attempt. Butler kicked one earlier. Of 46 yards. It's a 31-yarder. He kicks it, and it's up to the official. Then it hit the upright. The ball hit the upright, and a miss of 31 yards keeps the score 17-9 in favor of the Bears here at the midway point of the third quarter. The ball goes over to the Eagles, and let us take time out.
Hi, I'm Joe Isuzu. Ever wonder what a Jeep Cherokee owner says when he finds out the Isuzu Trooper comes with a 5-speed transmission, power steering, skid plates, carpeting, opening side windows, and reclining front seats all standard? Or what a Jeep Cherokee owner says when he learns that a comparably equipped base Isuzu Trooper costs over $1,000 less? You can say that again.
Now for a limited time, get a $750 factory cash rebate on the Isuzu Trooper.
The Eagles take over at their 14, still trailing by 8. Back in a moment.
Here's Whoopi Goldberg for the campaign to Give 5.
If every one of us gave just 5 hours a week to the causes we care about, it would be like mobilizing more than 20 million full-time volunteers just to tackle the problems of our society. We could all but wipe out drug abuse, juvenile crime, illiteracy, just 5 hours a week. But it has to start with somebody. So give 5. What you get back is immeasurable.
A public service of Independent Sector and the Ad Council.
Your body is one of the most finely tuned machines in existence. It can go from 0 to 15 in 5 seconds flat. But tinker with drugs, and you could leave it a wreck. This message was brought to you by the United States Marine Corps.
Eagles get the ball at their 20 following the missed field goal with 7:24 left in the third quarter. Bears on top 17-9. Philadelphia intercepted the last time they had the ball. Hank Stram and I will be in San Francisco tomorrow. The game between the 49ers and the Vikings, the other NFC divisional playoff. Tune in Brent Musburger's pregame show at 3:45 Eastern, sponsored by Saginaw Tilt Wheel. Earlier tomorrow, Randy Rasmussen and Brad Sham bring you the game between the Bills and Houston at 12:15 Eastern Time. Back to work, Cunningham. He starts Carter in motion, and he hands off on the running play. It goes up the middle. It's good for only a couple of yards with Anthony Tooney carrying the ball.
The last time he had the ball, Jack, he had 9 opportunities, threw the ball 8 times and ran only once.
Took the ball right down the field, and then they were intercepted by Bestie Jackson. So it is 2nd down and 8 at the 22 for the Eagles. Cunningham gets under center. And has Quick in motion. He's back to throw. He looks. He is chased, and he is knocked down. He got rid of the ball, however. And we don't know what the heck happened as we operate here in the fog trying to watch it on television. What did happen, Hank?
Yeah, it's a good question.
You're the coach.
All I see is a blank screen and a lot of fog.
And the ball was thrown and it was caught for a gain for the Eagles. Cunningham was almost sacked. He aborted the Chicago Bear rush. Somebody got a hand on him and he evaded that rush, threw the ball on the run. There's defensive pass interference, but the pass was caught for a gain for the Eagles. The play had started at their 22-yard line, so it is a 1st down. Just a short distance from the Soldier Field Stadium, the sun is shining here in Chicago. The ball is at the Philadelphia 35. Cunningham changes the play at the line of scrimmage. On a 1st down call, takes the ball, and he hands off on the running play. And a couple of yards over the right side.
I think he gave it to the ghost that time, Jack.
The ball comes out now to the 46-yard line, 2nd down and 6. 5:13 remaining in the third quarter of this game, and now the clock is running. Each team has had the ball in the second half. This is the 2nd possession for the Eagles. And one of the players is shaken up. 17-9, the Bears lead, and the officials have called a timeout. Let us take timeout.
Like millions of Americans, Rick Carpenter knows his family is depending upon him. So he watches what he eats, gets a physical once a year, and jogs 4 times a week. But there's one more thing Rick does to take care of himself and his family. He's covered by life insurance from the Transamerica Life Companies. Because no matter how healthy you are, it's nice to know that if you need us, we'll go the extra mile for your family. Transamerica. The power of the pyramid is working for you.
Philadelphia has the ball, trailing by 8. We're back in a moment.
Symptom, drooping eyelid.
First, they sent me to an eye doctor.
Symptom, total fatigue.
Then they called it anemia.
Symptom, partial paralysis.
I couldn't even move my arm.
Final diagnosis, myasthenia gravis, time wasted, 10 weeks. This is Tony Randall. More than 100,000 Americans will get myasthenia gravis this year. Many won't know it, because MG symptoms often lead to misdiagnoses. A simple test can determine if what you have is MG. Ask your doctor about it, because undiagnosed MG goes untreated. Untreated, it just gets worse. At the Myasthenia Gravis Foundation, we need your help to find a way to eradicate this killer disease. For further information, write to MG, 711 South Broadway, White Plains, New York, 10601. Or call 914-328-1717, and we'll send you a list of MG symptoms. And remember, if you have any of these symptoms, ask your MD about MG.
Keith Byers is the player who was shaken up. He's out of the lineup now. 2nd down and 6 for the Eagles near midfield. Here's Cunningham back to throw again. He waits and then throws the ball, and it is ruled.
Illegal motion.
Well, a whistle had stopped play before the snap of the ball. And a motion call against the Philadelphia Eagles. The worst seats here in Soldier Field are now the best seats. Those down on the playing surface are able to watch the action. Those fans with the, quote, good seats can't see a darn thing.
Illegal motion number 26 is declined.
This is the sixth eagle penalty. This one is declined, and it's third down and six. Third and six, the ball at the Philadelphia 48-yard line. Cunningham has been very unsuccessful on his third down throws. He gets under center. He is back to throw over the middle, and this one is broken up. Incomplete. Pass is incomplete, and the Bears will have to punt. And I hope you have to get down there and feel this punt, Hank Stram.
We need Red Grange. I wonder where Red Grange is, the old galloping ghost. He'd be great in this one, would he? Sean, like he was in all the other ones he played in.
Sean Smith broke up that pass play for Chicago Bears. Now the punter, Telchik, will kick the ball for the third time today. And the Bears get the ball for the second time in the second half. And there is the kick by Telchik. It bounces free, and everybody stays away from it in the fog, and it's going to roll dead inside the 20-yard line.
And in that kind of a situation, Jack, you sure don't want to have a man deep. You want to just make sure you don't fumble the ball. Unless you can see a lot better than we think we can see it from up here.
The ball rolled dead at the 15-yard line. There is a timeout. The Bears lead 17-9, third quarter. Let's take timeout.
Pepto-Bismol presents a maximum strength mask.
It's an overcast day at 3 Mile Stadium. Make that a wet day, and Coach Niedermeyer is hysterical.
Oh, and I'm wet!
Make that hysterical and wet. His nerf herders haven't made a third down conversion all day. The crowd is hostile. Oh, this is a mess. Coach Niedermeyer could go for the soothing relief of Pepto-Bismol about now. But on a day like today, I'm guessing he'll go for new maximum strength Pepto-Bismol.
Ouch!
Ooh, that's Niedermeyer's starting quarterback now on the bench with severely chapped lips. And that's the nerf herders turning the ball over again, which is why that crowd is now pelting Niedermeyer with hot dogs. Yes, when you've got a mess like this on your hands, there's new maximum strength Pepto-Bismol. Twice the medicine, twice the Pepto, dose for dose.
Coach Niedermeyer, please move your car. You're blocking the emergency exit. Coach Niedermeyer, move your car.
New maximum strength Pepto-Bismol.
Coach Niedermeyer, you also let your lights on.
When you're in a maximum strength mess.
Just over 100 miles to go. While you've already covered a lot of ground, you could go another 200 easily. Even cruising at full freeway speed, the road feels so smooth and so quiet, you can sit back, turn up the stereo, and truly enjoy the ride. You could only be driving a Buick with DynaRide suspension. No other car rides like a Buick. DynaRide, another reason why.
As the Bears and the Eagles battle, our chunky super lineman is Keith Van Horn, the right tackle of the Bears, who has kept the Eagles off his quarterback, Mike Tomczak. The chunky super lineman, sponsored by Campbell's Chunky Soup. It takes care of the meanest appetites. 4:22 remaining in the third quarter. The Bears are marked down at their 18-yard line. The quarterback is Tomczak. Bears leading by eight. Been unable to run the ball with much authority today. They run with Anderson going to the left, trying to turn the corner, and he can't get around the corner. And the clock continues to run as Anderson was knocked down after a 2-yard pickup. I know the play-by-play sounds strange, but we can't see the playing field from where we are. Anderson has run eight times today for 23 yards.
And we're desperately trying to see it on the monitor, but we can't. It's hard to even see it on the monitor.
Second down and eight for the Bears. They're up to their 20-yard line. The center is Hilgenberg. He snaps the ball to Tomczak, and Tomczak to Anderson, and hauled down from behind with a very strong play by Jerome Brown, who broke through there, and he lost the two he had gained earlier, and it's third and 10 for Chicago. Thing about it here, Hank, Chicago leading by eight, and they want to play conservatively. It's the Eagles who have to play catch-up ball, and they're throwing the ball, and successfully so.
Yeah, they have to be on the attack. They have to try to make something happen, and realistically, you know, they're a play and a half out of getting control of this game.
Bears are 4 out of 8 on third down. Last time the Bears had the ball, they missed on a field goal attempt. Ball back at the 18 again. Well, actually now at the 15-yard line. And it's third and long. Tomczak back to throw. He steps up and throws long over the middle, and it's intercepted on the deflection. Terry Hogue comes back the other way, and the Eagles have the ball on another Chicago turnover. That's their fourth of the day, this one on a tip ball. And Terry Hogue, who intercepted 8 during the year, comes up with another.
And there's a player down in the field. Looks, I can't tell who it is. It might be Tomczak.
Well, Tomczak is hurt, so we might see Jim McMahon. We have an official timeout on the field. And let's pause for this word.
30 seconds left, Coach. What's the next play? Huh? Hey, get him cough syrup.
Typical lineman, all brawn, no brains. Here, Coach, try a Vicks throat drop with instant action. Its medicine works on contact, so you'll get cough relief. You know, like a cough syrup, only faster.
Well, Coach...
Punt.
Punt?
Get instant action. Get a Vicks throat drop. Use as directed. And for those other times when you need extra vitamin C, try a Vicks vitamin C drop. How will you live in the next century? Suddenly, the pace will be quicker. Yet life will be smoother, more comfortable. Introducing the restyled 1989 Buick Century. With premium features you expect from the best-selling Buick on the American road. At a price that will let you enter the next century very comfortably. Welcome to the next century by Buick.
The great American road belongs to Buick.
Here's the reverse to Chris Carter, and he is... He threw the ball, and the pass was incomplete. The interception by Hogue, he returned the ball to the Chicago 17. Meanwhile, the quarterback, Tomczak, walked off the field under his own power. And Jim McMahon is starting to warm up along the sideline.
You know, I talked to Jim McMahon on the field before the game, Jack, and asked about his knee and everything. He's got a brace on his left knee that's so big, looks like a big bushel basket. I don't know how he could be very effective if he does get a chance to go in the game, and he hasn't played since October 30th.
2:25 remaining in the third quarter. And here's Cunningham back to throw. He looks left, he throws left, and it is in the end zone and incomplete. He tried to get the ball into the end zone to Carter. It was knocked down by Bestie Jackson. And it's going to be third down and 10. They have some dangerous wide receivers on this Philadelphia Eagle club with Quick and Carter and Jackson, the tight end. We don't know whether or not Byers has come back in since he was injured. He has not returned. And the Eagles are only 1 out of 9 on third down. And they have a third down now at the Chicago 17. 2:22 left in the third quarter. The Bears lead by 8. Cunningham will throw the ball again out of the shotgun. He steps up. He is on the run, chased, and he throws the ball. And we don't know what the heck happened. It is broken up. Try to get it down to Jackson. It's incomplete. And so Philadelphia will try another field goal. The PA announcer here is the most important man to the spectators here in the stadium. So trailing by 8, the Eagles, who have kicked 3 field goals and missed 1, will try another. Fourth down at the 17. This will be a 35-yard field goal attempt by Zendejas. The Bears missed on a field goal attempt a while ago.
They need a play and a half to get back in the game. This could be the half right here that they need.
There's the snap and the kick. And it is good. So the fourth field goal of the day by Zendejas makes it 17-12. A 35-yarder. By Zendejas, the first points here in the third quarter with 2:09 remaining in the third quarter. 17-12 our score. 5-point lead for the Bears. They were favored by about 5 or 6 coming into this game. Boy, the Eagles, Hank, if they lose this one, they'll be kicking themselves all over the lot.
Well, they're back in pretty good shape now, Jack, with just a touchdown behind. They got to continue to play good defense. and they got to continue to try to get turnovers, make big plays for the turnovers, so they don't have to go 75 or 80 yards for a touchdown.
It'll be interesting to see who the Chicago quarterback will be when the Bears get the ball on the ensuing kickoff. The Bears kind of sat on the ball the last time they got it, Hank.
I think they did, yes.
A couple of running plays and third and 10, and it was intercepted.
Yeah, I think they're trying to kill as much time as they possibly can and just win the game and get out of here.
And the winner of this one meets the winner of the San Francisco-Minnesota game, which was played at Candlestick Park tomorrow. Tom Zach has a bruised shoulder. That's the reason he had to leave the field, and it's doubtful that he's going to return, Henry.
Well, that's going to be a decision on the part of Mike Ditka as to whether he ought to put in a young quarterback, Harbaugh, who is just a youngster who hadn't been in a playoff game before, but he's healthy, or to take a chance with a man who hadn't got a snap in competition since October 30th and has a bad wheel, so in a flat tire. So it's hard to... Interesting decision that Mike has to make.
At the end of the game, we'll tell you the Transamerica power player of the game, Transamerica, where the power of the pyramid is working for you.
Look at this total offense.
In this quarter.
Yep.
The Bears only 23 yards.
Philadelphia 101.
Thomas Sanders and Dennis Gentry are going to be deep for Chicago as the ball will be kicked by Zendejas, who has provided all the points for Philadelphia, having kicked 4 out of 5. He missed his first field goal try, and now he's 4 out of 5. Tom Zach, if he's finished for the day, 10 out of 20. One touchdown, 3 intercepted. One of them on a tip ball. So Zendejas will kick it. And it's still extremely foggy here at Soldier Field. And there's the kick. We'll see who comes up with it. Returned by Dennis Gentry. And a modest return it is. And the tackle made by the Eagles on Gentry. And it's going to be Jim McMahon, coming into the game. Jim McMahon is the quarterback. The ball is at the Chicago 20-yard line. So McMahon will try to roll the Bears, who lead by 5. Let's pause 10 seconds for stations to identify themselves on the CBS radio network.
How much time?
1:42 left in the third quarter. First down Chicago with Jim McMahon playing for the first time in a long while. He is under center. And he's going to throw. He does throw. And it is caught. Caught upfield by Chicago. So McMahon is 1 for 1. The last time we talked to him was up in Minnesota, Hank. He had braces on both knees.
Well, he has them on today again, but he's got a new brace on the left knee, and it's much bigger than the one on the right knee. And he said it feels very comfortable, but it looks very bulky.
He passed for 7 yards on his first effort. Second down and 3 at the Chicago 27. McMahon under center again. And as we try to watch off the television set here, because we can't see in the fog, here's a running play up the middle by Anderson. And he's over the right side and got a couple of yards. And he ran for a first down across the 30-yard line. A 6-yard pickup by Neil Anderson. And this third quarter will be coming to a close very shortly. At the Bears' 34-yard line, and a first down call by McMahon. He threw on first down just a moment ago. And he hands the ball off, and Thomas Sanders runs with it and comes out to the 40-yard line. He got 6. 6-yard pickup. Roynell Young was the tackler. And that's the end of the third quarter, with the Chicago Bears leading by 5, 17-12 over the Eagles. Bears have the ball. Let's pause for this word.
Hi, Tom Bodette from Motel 6 with a tip for anyone heading south for the winter or anyone who's just plain tired of being Nanook of the North. I'm talking to you people who plug your cars in overnight, own snow blowers, and know better than to stick your tongue to anything metal outside. When you're migrating to warmer climates, why not stay at Motel 6 and save some money in the process? You'll get a clean, comfortable room, free TV and movies, free local calls and long-distance ones without a motel service charge, and all for around $22, the lowest prices of any national chain. There's even a swimming pool in most places, so you can put on your flip-flops, sit poolside, and write postcards to your friends back home. You know the ones I mean, the kind that say, greetings from sunny Florida or having a ball in Arizona. Well, for reservations, just call 505-891-6161. I'm Tom Bodette from Motel 6. Don't forget to take off those studded snow tires before you go, and we'll leave the light on for you.
Football fans, get ready for the battle of the century. As unbeaten Budweiser takes on undefeated Bud Light. It's Bud versus Bud Light in Bud Bowl 1. Pick up your official Bud Bowl scorecard wherever you buy Budweiser or Bud Light. Then use it to follow all the hard-hitting action. So get ready, get set. On February 22nd, Bud Bowl 1. This time, it's for real. Void where prohibited, no purchase necessary. Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
Foggy, foggy Soldier Field, Chicago. CBS Radio sports coverage of the National Football League is sponsored by the State Farm Insurance Company, by True Value Hardware Stores, and by Michelob. Hank, it's a shame that these teams have to play under this circumstance, but apparently they're seeing the ball all right down in the field.
Yeah, evidently, it seems a lot worse to us up here, evidently, than it is for the players. It's hard to imagine how they're being able to throw the ball like they are and see it as well as they do, but evidently that's the case on the field.
Each team has missed a field goal here today. The Bears were blanked in the third quarter. Second down and four at the Chicago 40-yard line as we start the fourth quarter. And the Bears in possession, leading 17-12. Sanders has rushed five times for 72 yards. He's the leading rusher today. Most of that yardage in one big chunk. Here's McMahon, the quarterback, and he hands it off to Thomas Sanders. He runs it right smack up the middle. Actually, with Brad Muster running with the ball. And he got 5 yards and another first down. Out to the Chicago 45 and a first down for the Bears. Jim McMahon relieving Mike Tomczak, who has a bruised shoulder. I'll tell you one thing, Hank, there's nothing wrong with McMahon's arm. We watched him throwing the ball last week up in Minnesota.
It ought to be terrific because it's got to be fresh. He's got a live arm, no question about that.
Here's a first down call for the Bears. McMahon gets under center. They're doing the play-by-play off the TV monitor. Here's a first down call. And here's a pitch to Sanders, trying to go the right side, trying to turn the corner. The fans over there cheer, so apparently he got a couple of yards. So Sanders the carrier. And we'll have to wait for the PA announcer, who's probably down on the playing surface, to tell us what's what.
36-yard line.
It's another first down as he carried down to the Philadelphia 36. A strong run by Thomas Sanders. Or the ball at the 36 is what we hear. 19-yard gain by Sanders. At the Philadelphia 36. So McMahon has him on the move. And he's under center for another first down call. And McMahon hands off on the running play. Here comes Neil Anderson breaking around the left side. He's out of bounds down inside the 20-yard line. A strong run by Neil Anderson. He was able to turn the corner, and we'll see where they mark the ball down. Somewhere around the 19.
He broke free. It looked like he might go all the way.
Is at the 13 of the Eagles and a first down for Chicago. And he was wrestled out by Eric Allen on the corner.
Time remaining, 14 minutes 46 seconds. 14-46.
14-46 remaining in the game. That was a 19-yard pickup by Neil Anderson. The ball is at the Eagle 13. McMahon has quite a drive going. A long snap count. And back to throw McMahon. He fakes out in the flat. He is on the move. Being chased, throws the ball, and apparently it's incomplete. Pass was incomplete, and it's second down and 10.
Second down.
The ball still at the Eagle 13-yard line with the Bears on top by 5, 17-12.
You know, surprising that the Eagles have been able, they've been able to run this well at this stage of the game against the Eagles, especially with Manning at the end of the game, because you know they want to keep as much time off the clock as they can running the football, so you ought to gang up there, stop the run, and make them throw.
This is the eighth play of the drive coming up, which started at the Bears 20. It's at the Eagle 13. McMahon with second and 10 is back to throw. And he hands off on the running play on the draw, and that is stopped by Philadelphia, and a bit of a scuffle breaks out. Mustard ran with the ball, but couldn't get much done. No gain. Third and 10 at the 13 for the Bears. The score here at the half was 17-9. In favor of the Bears. Clock running with less than 12 and a half left in this game.
13 minutes, 20 seconds. 13 minutes, 20 seconds.
Bears are 4 out of 9 on third down, and they have third and 10 now at the Philadelphia 13. This is fun, isn't it, Hank?
It really is, isn't it?
Here's a third down call by McMahon. He stands in the shotgun. Hilgenberg will snap the ball. Motion by the Bears. McMahon hands the ball off on a draw play, and it is not good enough for a first down as Anderson ran to the 8. And a field goal try by the Bears coming up. We had a 31-yard field goal miss by Butler earlier, and the Chicago field goal unit comes onto the field. It's the Bears by 5 at the moment. This will be a 26-yard try by Butler. Wagner, the punter, will hold the ball. As the Bears try to get their 8-point lead back again, that's the lead they enjoyed at the half.
And the kickers really experimented an awful lot before the game with cleats on their left foot to make sure that they wouldn't slide and slip.
Hilgenberg will snap the ball to Wagner, and Butler will try the field goal. There's the snap, and there's the kick, and it is good. 3 more points for Chicago. They now lead by 8, 20-12, and we have about 12 minutes left in the game. 20-12, Chicago, a 26-yard field goal. Let's take time out.
Here's why young parents feel better with life insurance from State Farm. You know the feeling. You know what formula, diapers, talcum, and 2 o'clock feedings are all about. You need life insurance, but you have a budget, and you hate life insurance sales talks. Well, instead of a lot of talking, your State Farm agent does a lot of listening. So you get a life insurance plan that feels just right for your family and your family budget, too.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm.
Hi, this is Pat Summerall for True Value Hardware, your store of first choice. Expand your video capabilities with accessories from Master Electrician. Connect 2 TV sets to 1 VCR with a VCR hookup kit, complete with 25 feet of pre-connected cable. And the video control box lets you easily switch to the TV, VCR, or home computer without rewiring. A simple switch begins with reliable Master Electrician accessories from participating True Value Hardware stores and home centers.
The world of car repairs can seem awfully uncivilized, but not with a lifetime service guarantee from participating Ford and Lincoln Mercury dealers.
Once you pay for a covered repair, it's guaranteed in writing with free parts and labor for as long as you own your car. Ask your dealer for a copy of the Lifetime Service Guarantee. It's peace of mind in an uncivilized world.
The Bears just went on a 70-yard drive, 10 plays, to get three more points. They lead 20-12 with 12 and a half left in the game, and Butler will kick it off to Philadelphia. Bears kept the ball for 4.5 minutes.
And talking about Butler, Jack, he's made 31 of his last 32 field goals inside the 40.
He had one hit the upright here today. And here's the kick by Butler. And it is a reverse on the kickoff return, a fake reverse, and the ball comes out across the 30-yard line, apparently, as we try to guess in the fog. We can't see the playing field at all. Whatever we're telling you on CBS Radio today comes from the television monitor.
And you have to have a pretty good imagination to even do that.
Now the Eagles are trailing by 8 points. Cunningham has been intercepted twice today. The kickoff was to the Philadelphia 31-yard line. Cunningham is 19 out of 36, but he's had two intercepted. One dropped in the end zone. A couple of touchdowns called back. Carter comes to the right. Cunningham gets under center. And he's back to throw on first down. He throws out in the flat, and it's knocked down by Sean Smith, the defensive end. And he wanted to intercept that ball, Hank, and darn near did it.
That's three times this afternoon that the ball has been knocked down by a defensive end, which means that the offensive tackle has not blocked him low enough to make sure he keeps the hands down.
Cunningham is one out of his last seven, so he is cooling off as the temperature rises here at Soldier Field in Chicago. 11:45 remaining in this game. Second down and 10 for the Eagles. The ball at their 31. Quick goes in motion back to the left side. Here back to throw is Cunningham again, and he runs with the ball. Throws on the run, and it's caught by Quick. And that's going to be good yards for the Eagles and a first down, apparently. So the pass went to Mike Quick. He just got up to the line of scrimmage and unloaded.
You know, Jack, the Bears' defense has been amazing. They've held 11 of 16 opponents to one touchdown or less this season. That's better than what they did in 1985 when they won the Super Bowl.
The ball is at the Philadelphia 49, and it's a first down after the pass reception by Quick. Here's Cunningham to throw again. He is chased out of the pocket. He throws on the run, and he overthrew his man. Incomplete. He tried to get it to Keith Jackson, the tight end, but Cunningham was dashing as he threw. And it's second and 10 from the Philadelphia 49-yard line.
The other interesting stat for the Bears, Jack, they have won 66 consecutive games when they have held the opponents to 17 points or less. Is that strong?
They have that strong defense, have had over the years, and this year they allowed only 83 yards rushing. And Cunningham calls the play again. Here's second down and 10. And back to throw, and there's the draw play, and it is Tony carrying the ball. He's good for 4 yards. Tony went to the Chicago 45, and it's going to be third down. Tony has rushed 8 yards, but only 12 yards today. Steve McMichael, Al Harris, Dan Hampton, and Sean Smith up front for the Bears. Here's a third down call for the Eagles, third and 6.
And he's only 2 of 10 on third down this afternoon, talking about Cunningham.
Third down has killed the Eagles today. Cunningham is in the shotgun. Takes the snap. Back to throw on the flat. And it is caught and the hit made immediately. But that's going to be a first down to Byers, who's back into the game. What a combination that is.
Well, that practice in the offseason, I really think paid off tremendously. It's very obvious. And listening to Myers talk about it, he's very, very excited about the progress he made as far as a pass receiver, and justifiably so, coming into this game with 72 catches.
The ball at the Chicago 39, and Myers, the leading receiver in the game, has caught seven. As Cunningham clicked up with him on that third down play. Here's a first down pass. He fakes short and throws long over the middle, and it's incomplete to Carter. He had the ball and then was hit by Maurice Douglas, and the pass incomplete, but Carter almost got up over everybody and made that catch.
I thought initially from the bad picture that we're looking at that he had the ball.
Carter, the wide receiver, went way up on top. Had the ball and then was dumped hard by Douglas, and it's second down and 10. .927 remaining in this game. And the Bears lead by 8, 20-12. Second and 10, Cunningham back to throw, and he runs with the ball, runs out around the right corner, gets some yards, and gets inside the 30, the 25-yard line. A big run by Randall Cunningham of 13 yards and a first down.
He's a player, and he's an athlete. That's the thing about him. You know, you can go along and miss some passes and look badly on a play or two and then come right back and make a big one and get you right back in the game and keep the drive going.
And then we have a penalty against the Eagles. And that really slows them down. It was only the second running attempt today by Cunningham, and he turned the corner, got away from three Bears, got inside the 40, 35, 30-yard line, and was knocked down at the 25, but a penalty.
Illegal block from behind.
Keith Jackson blocked illegally.
Philadelphia, the penalty is accepted. 10 yards, it'll still be second down.
You can see it in the picture, Jack, right on the sideline. He hit him in the back. Good call on the part of the official.
So it's second and 10, and the ball back to the 49-yard line of Chicago. Second down and 20. Trailing by 8, the Eagles trying to get that touchdown they desperately need. The ball is at the 39-yard line of Chicago. And the clock is running as the Eagles come out. From the Chicago 39, second and long. Cunningham under center, sets the club, and is back to throw. He sprints right a little bit and throws a screen left, and that ball's inside the 35 to the 30-yard line to Michael Haddix. He caught that screen and gained some yards, and they stopped the clock as he went out of bounds.
You know, the important thing, Jackie, is they have to get points, which is very obvious, but even if they get three, that's going to be important because if they get in within one touchdown of taking over the lead of the game, if they can play well defensively.
First down at the Bears 28 on a first down screen pass to Michael Haddix. You're right, Hank. They need that 8 points. They need that field goal and a touchdown. 8:49 remaining in this game.
They've got plenty of time. They just have to get points.
Cunningham is under center and back to throw. A quickie out on the inside and knocked down. And incomplete to Carter. He was stripped of the ball by Michael Richardson. Carter had it, but then Richardson hit him and was incomplete.
The collision popped it right out of there. Good play on Richardson's part.
That's a third drop pass by that receiver, Carter, today. And it's second down and 10. 8:40 left in the game as the fog still envelops the field here. Cunningham is 22 out of 43. 358 yards, but two interceptions. And it's second and 10 at the Chicago 28. They're already within long field goal range. Jackson, the tight end on the right side, and Cunningham back to throw. Short drop, quick pass, and this one is caught over the middle. And now it is ruled complete to Jackson. And an 11-yard pickup. Down to the 17 of Chicago. And another first down for the Eagles. Well, as long as they're in this close, Hank, the Eagles want that touchdown. But like you say, they need the field goal as well.
Yeah, they need two. They need a field goal and a touchdown, or, of course, two touchdowns to be great.
Now Cunningham on first down at the 17 is back to throw. He throws out in the flat, and it is incomplete at the goal line. Jackson was covering again. And they try to get the ball to Mike Quick. That Quick knows how to find the end zone.
Second and 10, 17.
Here's a second down call. These Bears will give up some yards, but when the going gets tough,
they really buckle down, don't they?
This is the 10th play of the drive coming up. After the field goal by Butler of the Bears. Second and 10 of the Chicago 17. Cunningham back to throw once again. Stays in the pocket. Now runs out of the pocket. And he throws on the run, and it's incomplete. The ball hit the deck, incomplete, and it's third and 10. And there's another flag on the play.
Incomplete. Offensive pass interference, number 26.
Offensive pass interference is the call.
That's Haddix.
Against Haddix.
I never saw a team in a game like this, Jack. I mentioned it before. And never have seen a team get so many penalties and make so many mistakes.
Well, you have to be careful whenever you accept a penalty.
Offense, number 26. The penalty is accepted. 10 yards. It'll still be second down.
Still second down. You have to be careful when you give Cunningham another crack at it, despite the yards that are marked off against him.
Plus, he has more room to throw the ball now. Now, Jack, with going back there 10 yards with this zone defenses that the Bears are playing.
Seven penalties against the Eagles, six against the offense. Second down and 20 at the Chicago 27. Cunningham to throw again. Looks and throws out in the flat. It's caught by Jackson, and he is knocked down after a worthwhile gain at the 18-yard line and a pickup of 9. It's third down. It is going to be third down. Third down and long for Philadelphia. Bears on top here, 20-12. Here's a big third down pass play. The ball at the Chicago 23.
He can't get a sack, and he's got to just make sure he tries to move off.
Cunningham is chased and sacked, and the whistle sounds, and that really kills him. As Al Harris got in with Sean Smith, and that hurts their field goal range. That's a fourth sack against Cunningham.
That's the one thing that you couldn't have happen. You got to say to yourself before you take the snap, I can get sacked. I got to try to get the ball down the field, get a little closer for the field goal, but I can't lose yardage. And that's exactly what he did. He lost yardage on the play.
You had just said that, Hank. You just said he can't get sacked. Smith gets his second sack of the day. The first one in there was Al Harris. Then Smith finished it off. The line of scrimmage is the 38 of Chicago. So they went backwards. And it's a punt by the Eagles, who trail by 8. John Telchek will punt. He can run the ball out of punt formation. This will be his fourth kick of the day. Chicago calls a timeout. It's a charged timeout against the Chicago Bears, who are about to receive the ball on this punt. The Bears lead 20-12. Let's take timeout.
Hi, Joe Isuzu here. Know what a Toyota truck owner says when he finds out the Isuzu pickup has more standard features? Ooh, he's angry. Or what a Nissan truck owner says when you tell him the Isuzu pickup has a larger payload, even though Isuzu is one of the lowest-priced trucks in America? Boy, am I glad I didn't tell him that you can get a $500 factory cash rebate on the Isuzu pickup. That's it. Let go of your anger.
Eagles were just sacked for the fourth time, and it really hurt them. We'll be back in a moment.
Since 1941, whenever our troops needed laughter, encouragement, and a little bit of home, the USO was there.
See, and I also have regards from you boys from Betty Grable. She sent you boys the regards. I'm sorry, that's all she sent.
Today, nearly 5 million military personnel and their families live in surroundings that are often unfamiliar, sometimes unfriendly. The USO is still there. Captain Bill Hayden, Executive Officer, USS Eisenhower.
When you guys take the trouble to come out here and visit us, we feel like the country's really behind us.
Without you, there'd be no USO, because the USO is supported by contributions from private citizens. So let our service people know that wherever they're serving, they're not forgotten. The USA still needs the USO, and the USO needs you.
John Telchik stands at midfield. He'll punt the ball to the Bears.
And you know why they called timeout, Jack? They wanted to make sure that he makes this guy kick the ball and that he doesn't take off and run with a football. That's why the Bears called timeout.
Telchik is a very good runner. And we await the snap to him. There's a low snap, and Telchik handles it. Tries for the out of bounds, kicks it to the sideline. It bounces inside the 10-yard line, and the Bears will start from their 11 at a 28-yard punt, and Telchik did a good job of dropping it at the Chicago 10. So Jim McMahon goes back to work. He's the quarterback after Mike Tomczak was shaken up earlier, and McMahon took him on one drive, which led to a field goal. And he's back in there now and asks the crowd to be quiet. McMahon asks the crowd to be quiet, and pretty soon that clock is going to really start hurting the Eagles in this playoff game.
Looked like he was doing a breaststroke there for a minute, Jack.
The ball is at the Chicago 11-yard line with 7:11 left in the game. And the Bears will try to move it and take off some of that time. They start motion by the tight end. Here is a toss to Anderson running left and comes out near the 13-yard line. 3 yards for Anderson.
You know what the defense has to do of Philadelphia? They've got to tackle the football. The second guy, after the first guy makes contact, they've got to go after the ball and somehow, some way, reduce the size of the field so they can get in there quicker without having to go the long distance of the field.
The Bears have turned it over a few times today. 4 times, 3 on interceptions. The Eagles took 5.5 minutes off the clock the last time they had it, but didn't get any points. And it's 2nd down and 7 for Chicago. The ball at their 14. Here's McMahon sticking it in the belly of Anderson again. He's good to the 16 for 3 more yards. It's 3rd down, and it is Andre Waters on the last tackle for the Eagles. 4 out of 10 on 3rd down for Chicago, and they face 3rd down and 5 now. 6 minutes remaining in the game, 20-12 in favor of the Bears. Terry Hogue checks in. 5:50 left in the game now. Clock running. The ball at the Chicago 16. 3rd down and 5. Again, the fog very heavy on the playing field here at Soldier Field. Motion by Gentry. In the shotgun, McMahon.
Philadelphia has it.
He's back to throw. He is sacked. And McMahon is sacked for the first time as Clyde Simmons and Reggie White got in there for the sack. And now Philadelphia will get the ball back in pretty good field position.
It's a good time for a timeout, too, Jack.
You're right. The Eagles have called timeout. About 5 minutes remaining in the game and a Philadelphia timeout. Bears lead 20-12. Let us take timeout.
If ordinary beer is wet, does that mean new Michelob Dry is dry? Well, you think about it. Let me pour you a Michelob Dry. Here's a beer that's brewed longer, so it starts bold, finishes clean, and refreshes completely. Here's a beer that, from all appearances, is wet, yet tastes dry. New Michelob Dry. One taste, and you'll drink it dry. Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
5:24. 5:24 left in the game, and the Bears are leading by 8, 20-12. This is only the second punt of the day for Chicago and Brian Wagner.
Now the question, Jack, is whether you want to take a chance, a rough on the kicker, to go after the kick to try to make a big play, or just say, let's not take a chance, and let's get some kind of return and try to get it that way.
Greg Garrity is back to get the punt. He should get it somewhere near midfield or in Chicago territory. Wagner needs a good snap. He gets it. He kicks it. And is there a flag? There is no flag. The ball is going to be returned by Garrity. Garrity returns the ball, and the Eagles have it again. So the Bears' defense will have to go to work. The ball is somewhere near the Chicago 41.
I thought at first there was going to be a penalty, roughing the kicker.
He just slipped and fell, but there were no flags down. And now we have an official timeout with the Bears leading 20-12. About 5 minutes left. We'll be back in a moment.
To some, it's a bridge between high school and the school of hard knocks. To others, it's a professional training ground. But if you think college is just a place where young people are preparing for their future, think again. Our colleges and universities are where America is preparing for its future. Let's face it, our world is becoming increasingly competitive. And now, more than ever, we're depending on a new generation of college-educated people to make our country smarter, stronger, to help America keep its competitive edge. That's why our colleges and their graduates simply must become a national priority. Government and business have their part, but so do we. After all, it's our future. So if you want America to stay number one in the world, do something about it. Give to the college of your choice.
A public service announcement of the Council for Aid to Education and the Ad Council.
Bears are taking advantage of the 8-point lead, Hank, and they're playing very conservatively and taking that time down.
Makes a lot of sense, and that's the way they should play.
Cunningham has thrown the ball 47 times today. Completed 24, 374 yards, no touchdowns, two interceptions.
And the Eagles have only had
38 yards rushing for the entire day. They have made enough mistakes to last them a lifetime, and this might be the end of their 1988 football lifetime unless they rally from the 8-point deficit with 5:10 left in the contest. And they have the ball in Bears territory. So Cunningham goes back to work again. They have it at their own 49, Philadelphia 49-yard line. Cunningham in the shotgun. Takes a low snap, and he's back to throw. Long down the middle, going for it all, and into the fog he threw it. And it is broken up by Todd Crum. So Cunningham went for the quickie that time.
Couldn't tell. Looks like they had a four-man rush and seven guys back there, Jack. But I don't think they're going to take a chance of getting involved in a one-for-one coverage. They give him the opportunity to get something quick.
He tried to get the ball to Mike Quick that time, and it's second and ten. The Eagles at their own 49, and Cunningham lines up in the shotgun again. Takes the snap and back to throw, and he does throw, and the pass is caught for a modest gain by Byers, and he is knocked down. Let's see what kind of forward progress he got. It's third down coming up. Third and two.
In this situation, too, Cunningham can't be timid as far as rushing is concerned.
And now here's a quick snap of the ball, and the pass is thrown incomplete. As they try to get it out to Haddix, and it's fourth down. And now it's gambling time for the Eagle, right, Hank?
It sure is.
Fourth and two at the 43. So the Eagles, trailing by eight, can hardly afford to give it up to Chicago here. They come out of the huddle needing 2 yards on fourth down. They've been good on fourth down this year, 8 out of 12. Cunningham back to throw. Fourth down. He drops it short over the middle. It's caught for a first down by Byers. You knew he'd be the man. And another first down.
You knew it was either going to be Byers or Keith Jackson. One of the two in this situation. And he got it to Byers. And everybody knew he was going to get it to Byers or the other tight end.
It's another first down for the Eagles in a hurry-up offense. They're at the Chicago 30. Here's Cunningham to throw again. He throws long downfield, and the pass is incomplete. And that will stop the clock. He tried to get the ball to Chris Carter. He was covered by Richardson.
Time remaining, 4:08.
4:08 remaining in this game.
With the zone defenses that the Bears are playing, crossing patterns would be very good to get guys coming across in layers, one short, one medium, and one deep across the middle area some way, Jack, to get take advantage of that zone.
Byers has caught 9 passes today. This is the 6th play of the drive coming up. 4:05 left in the game. In the shotgun is Cunningham. He runs with the ball in a quarterback draw, and he gets a few yards. And he is tackled by Dave Durison. And the clock continues to run. 3:50 remaining in the game.
And the Bears are loving this. Cunningham's got the ball, but they're taking so much time off that clock.
Here Cunningham back to throw, and he throws inside the 25. Caught by Haddix, and he dives down for good yards. And another first down to the Bears 16. Another first down for the Eagles. First downs have not been their problem.
No, it hasn't been. They have taken advantage of the good opportunities. They've been their problem.
Hurry up offense again from the 16. Cunningham to throw. He throws on the left flat. And the ball is intercepted, apparently, the other way by the Chicago Bears. The Bears have the ball, stopping another drive. It happened in the fog on the far side of the field, and the third interception against Cunningham. We don't know who got the ball, Hank.
No, absolutely incredible the way that Bear defense has played this afternoon. Of course, not only the way they played this afternoon, but all season long. They have been just fantastic.
It was Maurice Douglas, the safety man, only his second of the year. And the Bears have the ball and still have the 8-point lead, 20-12. That's a third interception against Cunningham. Randall Cunningham has moved the team up and down the field, but couldn't get into the end zone.
And the Bears basically have stayed with that zone defense, Jack. Hate to belabor a point, but they normally play an awful lot of man-for-man, especially in that scoring area. And they've been very patient to stay in it and wait for the Cunningham and the Philadelphia Eagles to make some kind of a mistake. And they've made them here this afternoon.
Now McMahon quarterbacking again after Tomczak had to leave the game. A long snap count, hands it off on the running play. And it is Muster running with the ball, and he can get nothing done over the right side. And we're trying to get a line as to how much time is left in this game.
Philadelphia
calls timeout. That's the second timeout that they have used. Eagles use their second timeout. The Bears leading 20-12 with 2:54 remaining in the game. Well, later today we're going to have Seattle at Cincinnati, 3:45 Eastern time. And then tomorrow, both games will be on CBS Radio. Hank Stram and I will be in San Francisco, and Brad Sham and Randy Rasmussen will be in Buffalo after they work for CBS in Cincinnati today. And then both the AFC and NFC championship games will be on CBS Radio next Sunday, a week from tomorrow, on the 8th of January, with the times and the sites to be determined. Now the fog starts to lift here. 2:54 left in the game. The ball is at the Philadelphia 36. Now we're able to see the players again. Second down and 10. The interceptions and other items have really hurt the Eagles today.
Talking about those mistakes, Jack, 3 turnovers by Philadelphia, 1 missed field goal, 4 drop passes, 7 penalties, and 3 times inside the 20-yard line, and they only get three field goals.
And a missed field goal here. Neil Anderson running for good yards as he's down near the 30. Mike Pitts made the tackle at the 31. And now the Eagles will get the clock on the 32nd mark. Anderson has rushed 15 times, 55 yards. And the Bears have a third down coming up, third and five. At the Philadelphia 31. You're right, Hank. That litany of mistakes by the Eagles is overwhelming.
It really is. It's just staggering.
4 out of 11 on third down for the Bears. The ball at the Eagle 31 with 2:20 left and the clock running. It's third down and five. Motion by the tight end. McMahon with a toss to Sanders. Sanders turns upfield and he's stopped. No gain. And the clock will go down to the two-minute mark. And it's fourth down. This would be a long field goal try if the Bears were to try it of 47 yards. So we'll see what they do after the two-minute warning. We have 2 minutes left in the game. Chicago leading 20-12, and let us take time out.
Thank goodness you're here, officer.
Okay, now what seems to be the problem, ma'am?
It's my Binky.
Don't tell me. Binky stuck up a tree?
No, he's locked himself into our new Mercury Cougar.
Say, that's a new one.
He loves listening to the 4JBL audio system.
Binky is listening to the 4JBL audio system?
Yeah, Mozart.
Now, let me get this straight. Your cat is listening to Mozart.
What cat? Binky's my husband.
Oh, well, you see, I...
He locked himself in right after we bought the car.
Now, when was that?
3 weeks ago.
3 weeks ago?
Uh-huh.
Is that Binky curled up on the dashboard?
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Listen to the 4JBL audio system with 9 JBL speakers, including a separately powered subwoofer. Also available in Ford Thunderbird.
All right, come on out, Binky. You played your last tune.
No way. I still got the rock version of their Fleeter Mouse.
Okay, I'm calling for backup, ma'am.
Oh, is that really necessary?
I'm afraid so. It's a double album.
Oh, no.
Ford Audio Systems, the sound of quality.
All right, Binky, we've got you surrounded. Drop your cassettes and come out with your hands up. Now, you have the right to an attorney or a veterinarian.
I knew from day one that my Army Reserve job in the medical lab is an important one.
That's Private First Class Manuel Aguilar, Army Reserve.
As a lab specialist, I provide critical information our doctors need to make life-saving decisions. The Army Reserve taught me how to do it, and do it with confidence.
To your local Army recruiter. Paid for by the Army Reserve.
We have 2 minutes left. The band here plays Auld Lang Syne, and the crowd joined in the singing. We wish you a happy new year from CBS Radio. We'll have more action for you on the 31st tomorrow, both games. And that should be a good one in San Francisco tomorrow, Hank.
I sure really should be. Two excellent football teams in the San Francisco 49ers and the Minnesota Vikings.
Here's a fourth down, and the Bears are going to go from scrimmage. Fourth down and five at the Philadelphia 30-yard line. With 2 minutes left, Dennis Gentry comes off on a wing. McMahon apparently to throw the ball. He'll make it a safe pass if he can. Gentry in motion. Anderson in the backfield. Here's McMahon to throw. Swings it out in the flat. It's turned upfield by Anderson. Gets a first down. And that's probably going to ice it for the Bears with 1:50 left. A 6-yard pass. And the Bears keep the ball. Terry Hogg made the tackle.
A pound of nails in the coffin now, Jack.
And the clock continues to run, and Philadelphia has one timeout remaining. So apparently the Bears are going to win by 8, Henry.
It sure looks that way.
A first down pass play to Anderson. He made sure he caught it, then he turned upfield and got the first down. 1:15 left in the game, and here is the running play. And this time it is Brad Muster carrying the ball for a couple of yards over the left side. Clock runs down near the one-minute mark, and it has to be a terribly disappointing game for the Eagles.
Oh, it has to be.
They did everything but win it.
Well, it's one thing. Yeah, it's one thing to get beat, but it's another thing to lose the football game, and that's what they've done here this afternoon. They've lost the football game.
The Eagles have called a timeout. It's their last timeout of the game. The Bears lead with 53 seconds left, 20-12. Our Transamerica power player of the game this afternoon is Dennis McKinnon of the Chicago Bears. four passes for 108 yards and a touchdown. And tomorrow we'll select another Transamerica power player of the game. Transamerica, where the power of the pyramid is working for you. Hank, let's see if we can remember all these things. There were three interceptions. How many drop passes do we have?
For Philadelphia?
Yeah.
They had four drop passes. One, of course, was for a touchdown.
And then two touchdown passes on the same series were caught back because of penalties.
Yep.
And the number of penalties against Philadelphia today, a total of
seven
penalties, plus the missed field goal, plus the fourth and goal where they didn't make it. It's a terrible list of things from a Philadelphia viewpoint. A couple of more snaps of the ball, and this game will be over. And then CBS will switch you to Cincinnati for the Seattle game, which will be starting very shortly after we throw it over there.
It's a long list that we just
read
off.
Here's McMahon putting the ball down.
And not the kind of a list you'd like for Christmas.
A little scuffle breaks out now after that last snap, and the clock continues to run. Andre Waters got into it a little bit along with Seth Joyner. Andre Waters likes to mix it up. 40 seconds left in the game, and now Joyner is shaken up on the play, and they stop the clock, but they'll take 10 seconds off the clock before they snap the ball again. And so one more snap of the ball. When you get an injury timeout in the last 2 minutes and you have no timeouts remaining, it costs you 10 seconds.
Exactly 10 seconds.
So they'll sit on the ball and crank it down. Hank, I'm surprised that Reggie White wasn't more involved in the game than
he really wasn't. It's amazing. It was amazing. The other thing was amazing. We never had occasion to mention McMichael in the whole
game. But Chicago played that containing defense, and they didn't want Cunningham to run, and he ran only a couple of times today, and once effectively for a first down. Joyner is helped off the field, but now they're going to take 10 seconds off the clock. McMahon will snap it one more time, and the Bears will have won it 20-12, and they're going to be in the championship game here next weekend.
That's right.
No matter who wins that Minnesota-San Francisco game.
We got the old boomerang shot. We leave here and come right back next week.
You're right about that. Cunningham made that one long run for a first down, but even that was called back because of a penalty. Now they take 10 seconds off the clock. One more snap of the ball, and Mike Ditka's team has defeated Buddy Ryan's team.
And the last time they played, Bears won in an overtime by just 3 points.
They snap the ball. We're down to 8 seconds. 7-6, and in a very heavy fog here at Soldier Field, Chicago, this game is over. And the Bears have won it to advance to the championship game. 20-12, the final score. Back in a moment.
And here it is, the big question that can win George and Marion the kitchen of their dreams. Decorated in their choice of shocking pink or old English lavender.
Oh,
all easily assembled with simple hand tools.
A pink kitchen?
George, we can always paint it brown.
Okay, folks, listen carefully. It's a first aid question.
Uh-huh.
Just answer true or false. When someone has an epileptic seizure, you should put a spoon or some other hard object in the mouth.
Oh, that's true.
So they won't swallow their tongue.
Uh-huh.
Folks, that's wrong, wrong, wrong. You don't put anything in a person's mouth if he's having a seizure. If you want to help, turn the person on his side to keep the airway clear. And don't panic. Seizures generally aren't a big deal, and they only last a minute or two.
Yeah, but I thought...
And epilepsy. It's not what you think. Get the facts. Call Epilepsy Foundation of America, 1-800-EFA-1000.
For international delivery service that really measures up, call Flying Tigers. At Flying Tigers, they're taking care of business. That's it for today's championship game, divisional championship game from Soldier Field. The Bears beat the Eagles 20-12 in Chicago. Now the Bears play the winner of tomorrow's 49er Viking game here in Chicago next weekend. Our engineers today, Ed Murphy and Bill Karambelis. Our spotter, Ray Stallone. Our statistician, Pat McGrath. Our producer, Bill Severa. Working with us in New York, Don Frazier, Paula Siliberti, Steve Bombard, and Art Starr. Pre-game and halftime producer, Jim Hunter. Thanks also to Donna Zelazny and David Kerman. The executive producer of CBS Radio Sports is Frank Murphy. Join CBS Radio Sports tomorrow, another doubleheader. Bring you the game between the Bills and the Oilers at 12:15 Eastern, and then the 49ers and the Vikings at 3:45 Eastern. And now stay tuned for today's second game. Randy Rasmussen and Brad Sham will call the action. The Bengals and the Seahawks in Cincinnati. For Hank Stram and Brent Musburger, Jack Buck saying so long for CBS Radio Sports.
You want more than just the scores? I'm Mike Cairns, and I've got them for you every weekday morning right here on your sports leader in the Capital District, WQBK-Rensselaer, Albany, Schenectady, Troy.